Hills, shrubs grown right here in Nebraska. Lenaha Nurseries, your homegrown headquarters since 1974.
Tickets for less. Best seats, best prices, no service fees. Shop ticketsforless.com. KOZN Bellevue, Omaha, Council Bluffs. This is 1620 The Zone.
Crossover. Oh, killer crossover.
Just crossover.
It just crossed him over. Absolutely.
Another victim to the crossover. Cross him up and sit him down.
The crossover is powered by Everlevel Concrete Repair in Omaha at everlevelconcrete.com. These guys are here still.
Hey, what's going on?
We're still here. Hi, guys.
Wow, this is... What do we do now?
Hi. Probably three more hours of fantastic radio.
Yeah, I moved. We moved. We switched spots.
And now I get to be a guest on my favorite show.
Oh, you're too kind.
On Sportsmanlike Conduct.
Oh, you like the producer, right?
Now, what does it mean when your favorite radio host's radio show, I'm the guy who hosts that show, but my favorite show is this show?
Oh.
How does that describe your guys' show?
That you like fun and frivolity and John Bishop.
Fun!
You're a big fan of John Bishop.
I do love John Bishop.
And everything John stands for.
And my favorite John show is the Connor Happer show.
Oh, wow, Josh.
I don't think you can like your own show.
Josh, that's like when they do the preseason coaches polls and the coaches are not allowed to vote for their own team. Yeah. You're being a Geno Auriemma right now, but you're voting for UConn.
Well, I don't want to be a Geno, so I'll vote for USC.
Okay. All right. Well, there we go. Awesome. Sorry to all the other radio shows.
Your favorite shows, radio host's favorite radio show.
You're my favorite show for the
week. I'm producing my favorite show.
Whoa, now Joey
likes this show.
Wow, tough look for the midday show.
I can't believe you would say that.
Hey,
Tapper,
Connor,
your
show's number two.
Many of them.
Morning show's got to be in the bottom because they got to get up early.
It's way too early.
Oh, so that's why early. Joey, it's not that he is dissing the show. He is just saying it's too early for me.
Joey's a late night guy.
Oh, is he? Is he like Josh? Is he in like he likes Josh time?
I'm going to be a morning, afternoon, and late night tomorrow, so I'm going to be here all day. I'm probably going to live here then.
Yeah, you guys should know, like, everything that – if there's ever a sports game on 1620 The Zone, Joey's probably producing.
Joey is our man. Yeah. Joey, did you know – here's a compliment to Joey. John was very sad when he learned that Joey wouldn't be producing the Creighton game tomorrow.
I am producing the game tomorrow. I had discussions with the producer who was originally scheduled, so I will be doing Creighton tomorrow night.
Dang, Joey pulled rank.
Threw his weight around.
Yeah, when he noticed that I was producing that Akron game, he was happy and said, "Yay, we got the A team." I guess that was a compliment.
Wow.
John loves you, Joey.
Yeah, I know. Joey, John wouldn't shut up the other day about how much he loves that you cut highlights live, and then I said to something about, Nick, why didn't you do that? And then Nick came up with some excuses.
I was busy.
I'm busy.
He's busy.
So yeah, shout out to Joey.
I don't want to do it.
Wow. Sorry, Nick. You might be getting funnier, but we're still going to make fun of you, I guess.
Yeah.
It's kind of how things roll.
Shut up, Joey.
I don't want to go to
the maturation of you getting...
I don't like the weather in Omaha. Let's go to Vegas, guys.
Oh, it is pretty nice.
That does sound like Nick.
Yeah,
it does.
Classic Nick.
He loves to travel.
I famously travel all the time.
Hashtag ice cream and airplanes. Get it going.
Everywhere.
By the way, we're watching the giant screen, and we're watching our own screen inside of Cabana.
Yeah.
And it's the best part of opening day. They're all lined up.
It's great.
Why is that the best part?
It's so cool.
Josh Odson, don't you love when they line up?
I need the pomp and circumstance of opening day.
Question.
Yes. I need
full question.
I need the bunting, not the baseball bat bunting, but the ribbons on the stands.
Me too.
I need all of that.
Something about like a 2 or 3 o'clock start to the nice clean home
but
uniform.
But it's so chilly.
There's no alternate uniforms on opening day. It's just pristine.
Here's my take. I don't understand why baseball season begins and they play in so many of the northern cities. Why can't the schedule makers give us some southern baseball?
Josh, have you ever heard of tradition?
Josh says, why can't the South rise?
No, I just want, why can't the South have some baseball? Is that why they do it after? Is that why Baltimore is hosting a game against the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim
today?
You
just play baseball. It's
It doesn't.
I don't know ball.
You just play baseball. Like wherever you're at, you play baseball.
I guess so.
Let them ball.
Mm-hmm. You know, if you want to play in October when like the World Series is, tends to also be cold then.
It is chilly. It's hard to argue with that.
Unless it's 2020 and the whole World Series is in that giant monstrosity in
Globo Gym Stadium.
Yes, Globo Gym Stadium. Mm. Exactly. Man, but yes, we're very fired up. I might go down there and just place a bet right now.
I would just like to point out, I've been told that the Yankees are playing in Texas. There you go, Josh.
The Yankees, okay, that's a southern state. Well, I don't know if the South considers Texas a part of them, but they are in the South.
That state is a monster. That stadium is a monstrosity.
It looks like a weird, like, kitchen appliance.
It's Globo Gym Stadium.
Well, hold
and
on.
It's got turf.
Hold on.
It does. Nick, Google it.
Nick said that the Yankees are playing in Texas. What he meant by that is... the city of the Houston, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Which is in Texas.
Yes, it
he
is.
He said they're playing Texas, I thought.
I said they're playing in Texas.
Oh, okay.
In the state of
yeah,
Texas.
I would have said if they're playing the Astros, I would have said they're playing in Houston. That's how I would have described
he'll
it.
Learn. He'll learn. He'll learn.
I thought we were just talking about states and regions and South.
Interesting.
Does Nick have a microphone, or is he just shouting at you guys?
Dude, I don't know why this has been so hard for Nick today.
I don't know if it's a me problem.
There we go.
He's usually a good producer.
Is.
He's
ah!
himself. Jeez.
Hello.
You don't have to scream.
Well, I don't know if it's working or not. See, now it sounds too much.
The only way to figure out if it's working is to scream into it.
Hello. Hello. Why don't you, like, do that?
Because it won't stay.
Interesting.
Well, yeah. Okay, this is a human error. Mm. Yeah, he's got to pull his microphone closer to his head.
I didn't mean to call attention to it. I was just wondering.
It's the hat. No, you know what it is? I'm realizing it's the backwards hat. Is the bill is leaning it away in the back.
But my hat was forward earlier, and we were having
You need to get that microphone in front of your face, baby.
Yeah, maybe it's your head.
Eat it like Mike Greenberg.
That's what our old boss, Neil Nelkin, used to say, swallow the mic.
Yep. Mm.
He would love saying that to women. Swallow the mic. That's what he would say.
Nice.
Which is why he's had to retire several times.
He's back.
Oh no, he's still doing radio.
Yeah, it's okay. I feel like it's right there. I don't know what else you want from me.
You sound the best you have all day now.
Wow. Cool. The best he has all day. Well, Nick, you better get that mic figured out because we have to do content later.
We do. Ooh. I've already got it ready.
I don't know what time because we're off early today. We have to figure out what time we're going to do all of these various segments.
Time, like vacation, is a construct.
John is sending us all sorts of things.
Yeah, we got a bunch of John segments.
Yeah, Robin is coming on the show.
Robin will be on the show.
The guy from Circa.
Mike Palm will be on the show.
Mike Palm. What a name. I've seen Mike Palm walking around with a Detroit Tigers jersey.
I actually was
wrong.
That's a different guy. Oh. I realized it's a different guy.
Not Mike Palm.
Not Mike Palm. Yeah, you can ask him about his coworker in the Detroit Tigers jersey, though.
Okay.
Yeah.
Denver has put the biscuit in the basket, boys.
Oh, have they?
They Denver lead, scored a hockey goal?
Yeah, they lead 1-0 over UMass.
I told you that Denver was good. What'd I tell you about Denver?
You did. By the way, I just realized we never talked to Greg Maddux.
That's right.
Nope. No Greg.
Oh, no.
I noticed that.
Yeah.
Josh noticed.
I was going to ask him about his off-speed pitch. Never got a chance to.
Cody says, Josh and I handshake meme, baseball is so stupid.
Hell yeah, Cody. Good take, bro.
Can't believe you're here celebrating opening day and you're like,
I'm not here celebrating.
You're celebrating opening day and college basketball and you're like, I hate both of those things.
You know what I know?
Yeah, why did you get to go?
Interesting.
What was that?
It should have been me, Happer, and Austin.
Yeah, well, you got to fix your microphone, Nick, or else I can't hear what you're saying. Boom, roasted.
You know, I realized
should have been Joey, man.
Should have been Joey.
No, because then John would be mad, and he would have been like, Joey, I'm going to buy you a return ticket.
I do have flight
home.
Benefits. My sister is a pilot. She's going to be a pilot for one of the airlines. So I can fly standby.
Wow. I never would have expected that.
A sweet
perk. Can you get Connor in a cockpit? We have a bit we want to try out.
Oh, that would be great.
I'll ask my sister's boyfriend. He's a captain for Delta.
Nice.
Ooh. Whoa.
Yeah, this we could start making this bit happen.
Get that man behind the wheel. That's what they're saying.
I'll check the next time he's flying to Omaha.
I believe it's called a stick.
Yeah, get him behind the yoke.
Yeah.
Yoke.
Nick, okay, what I'm realizing
move it
is...
to the front of your...
Yeah,
face.
It's. I'm realizing it's, so it's here.
It's not supposed to go over my ear then?
Well, it is, but apparently your face is too long. I don't know what to tell you.
Yeah, the microphone is supposed to be where your mouth is.
Right. But I thought the earpiece was supposed to be where my ear was.
It is.
Yeah, well, there's just some things...
Amazing.
It's
gotta be,
this part's more important.
Yeah.
This is the better part.
It really is.
You have another one of these. It's over here.
Oh, man. Okay, well...
Does that microphone arm move so that he can make his ears and his mouth both work?
Wow.
This is going to be an interesting show.
We've triggered Nick.
We have.
For the first time.
Shout out to us. It only took until the second day's worth of shows.
Yeah, it's good.
We have done 8 hours worth of radio, and now is the first time that Nick has seemed actively annoyed with us.
I only get triggered when you guys imply I don't know how to do my job and don't know how microphones work.
Well,
I did go to school for this.
You're the only one with microphones.
Are you sure they taught that in Iowa Western? How to put headsets on? I don't recall that being a course.
You didn't go to Iowa Western.
Yeah, but I talked to people who did.
You're not a reaver.
Yeah, thankfully.
I can confirm that they do tell you, and Joey can as well, that they, you know, they tell you to put the headphones over your ears.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the reaver boys are offended over there.
Well, sorry.
Yeah. Can we move the camera view so we could see Nick struggle?
Oh yeah, we never have seen Nick today. There he is.
Hi.
There he is.
I'm here, too.
Yeah.
Is that a mirror above
us? He looks great.
A mirror.
Wow, that's so
he's
fun.
Got that deep V going, and he's got that tuft of chest hair coming out.
Yeah, you like that tuft?
That's just a beater, I think.
I'm very surprised at learning things about Nick the more I see him, like, taking off his clothes or wearing less clothes. He's a very hairy man. Yeah. I never would have guessed it from Nick. You know, you think of, like, guys who are into emo music, and I expect them to be bare-chested.
Also, okay, we got Nick on the...
On the scale.
The giant scale for the Heart Attack Burger place last night. And you, like, way undershot his weight.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's a positive.
I fluctuate a lot.
You're a big guy.
Yeah, I never would have guessed
Nick is a big guy.
Again, you think of someone who listens to emo music, and I don't expect them to weigh as much as Nick weighs.
That's right.
I don't know what this means.
Especially with someone who only eats rice.
You got some power behind you. I'm surprised that Mr. Casey didn't like you as a running back or something.
Guard.
He wanted me to be on the line and the line only.
Mm-hmm.
I tried to be a tight end. He's like, no, get off. Get away from me.
Gotta have the foot speed, I guess.
You're a tackle, but a right tackle.
Asian Joe says, I hope the mic struggle is a part of today's Vegas vlog.
Oh, Nick, yes. Why don't you start recording video of this?
Record video of this.
Okay. Yeah, and edit it together.
Okay.
I need to watch the Vegas vlog from yesterday. I didn't realize it until I sat down for breakfast. Nick was finishing up his breakfast. Happer hadn't gotten his breakfast. Mm. And Nick was like, I did a vlog.
I did a vlog.
Oh, I need to watch this.
I watched it already.
How is it? How would you grade it, Joey?
I would put it at a B minus C. It was mostly just watching you walk around, Josh, around the facility. And it was speed up because there was so much walking.
I mean, that is, to be fair, that is kind of all we did yesterday.
That's Vegas for you, right? Vegas is about walking.
Not a whole lot of commentary.
No, he wanted some commentary.
Oh, he wanted commentary.
He wanted some commentary.
I mean, it's hard to
do. He wanted a narrator.
I'm going to shout out Nick on this. It's hard to do, like, total editing. I don't even know how you did it.
I did it on my phone.
Yeah, that's difficult. It's hard to add narration to the proceedings, right? That'd basically be impossible. So I'll defend Nick and his walking.
Thank you.
That's what we did yesterday. We got a slice of pizza.
We just walked, yeah.
We got some fries. Everyone, by the way, keeps expecting us to get, like, super hammered on this trip and, like, do all sorts of crazy stuff.
This is a work trip.
This is a work trip. We have to be on the air at 8 o'clock, you know, here. Mm-hmm. Also, I am 35 now. I'm just not into that like I used to be.
Maybe the three-man weave guys are getting hammered.
We should ask them. Hey, are you guys getting drunk tonight?
Should we do a crossover and we do their podcast and they do our radio show?
They would hate me. Their audience would despise me.
We call that the unsportsmanlike weave.
Can we talk college football on this podcast? That's what I would ask them.
The three-man conduct?
What do you guys think about college football? Has the transfer portal ruined college basketball?
You could talk about how college football has impeded college basketball, and it has ruined college basketball because of all the greed of the conferences and things like that.
There'd be a handshake meme on that one. Yeah, I wonder what teams these guys like.
I don't know.
I should ask them. I followed them on Twitter. We'll see if they have good tweets.
Yeah, we'll see if they do some good tweets.
I have a college basketball take I'd like to unleash.
Oh, awesome. Sports.
It's actually more of a sports media take. Sports media, stop interviewing old college basketball players and asking them about NIL, because we know what their answer is going to be.
That's a good take.
The damn spoiled kids. They did it to Christian Laettner today, and I'm sick of seeing old men yell about NIL.
I don't hate that take.
Yeah, I'm fine with that, too.
Thank you.
I don't need to see that
anymore. Josh, what would you say is the time when – like, we need to stop talking to former players? Like, it's been how many years since their career ended? Ooh. It's okay to move on.
10 to 20, depending on the greatness of the player.
Okay.
We can just ignore them when they
just
get
like,
old.
You just don't need their opinions on things anymore.
I disagree. I think we can talk to old people.
Steve Sipple much?
I love Sipple.
No, but Steve Sipple loves talking to old people. Something happened. Let me call Tom.
I like getting their opinion. We don't have to ask them about NIL stuff that they'll have bad takes on. But their perspective can be good. Yeah, their perspective can be good on things.
Was that Josh's impersonation of Tom Osborne?
And gambling's bad.
Well, you're doing a good job.
I didn't know what that was.
It's the mouth. It's the mouth feel. Me, Tom.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have an announcement to make.
Yeah, what's that?
Corbin Burns has just thrown the first pitch of the 2024 MLB season.
Wow.
We are underway. It was a cutter right in there to Anthony Rendon, who actively hates baseball. And here we go.
We're back,
here
baby.
Here we go.
It's always weird seeing the first baseball game when everyone looks so cold, and then the sport is played when it's really hot, but then it ends again when it's cold.
Covers many seasons.
Long
the
sport.
Passage of time. Three seasons in one with baseball.
Men come up to Josh with tears in their eyes.
Tears in their eyes.
Tears in their eyes.
Yes, sir, I love the weather.
I'm looking at Royals Live right now from Sunny Kauffman Stadium.
Oh, wow.
Ryan LaFever, Rex Hudler.
Where's it at?
It's in Kansas City,
no,
baby.
Wait, no, where's the
bottom middle?
Oh, there it is. I see it.
Yeah, bottom middle.
Oh, wow. Nick almost made it.
I banked it yesterday. Happer thought.
Wow.
Mm. Okay. Well, I think the crossover is over.
Josh, great to see you, friend.
We'll do it tomorrow.
We'll talk to you tomorrow. Jacob, do we stop talking to former players or just stop giving them radio shows? No, if they have radio shows, they're allowed to speak and give their opinions.
Yeah, that's the exception that proves the rule.
Yes, it's just more like, why do we need Christian Laettner's thoughts on anything? No offense to Christian. He had his time, Happer. He had his time.
We don't need his thoughts on anything.
Where's Ja Rule to make sense of this? Why are we doing that with Christian Laettner? Where's Christian Laettner?
You don't need to ask about everything, but maybe some things.
What would you like to ask him about?
What was it like to make a shot that was heard around the world? You had the biggest NCAA tournament shot of all time.
I think he's been asked that before.
He has. That's not a very good question. Hmm. But that was the crossover powered by Everlevel Concrete Repair in Omaha at everlevelconcrete.com. We will talk to Josh Hodson again tomorrow on the Connor Happer Show and then in the crossover. But the program live from Las Vegas, an abbreviated edition, begins next here on 1620 The Zone.
Previously on The Crossover.
I have mostly sports things that I want nothing to do with muted.
Okay.
Major League Baseball, muted. Baseball, muted.
I thought you loved the Mets.
I did. Yeah. Mahomes, Chiefs, Harbaugh, Wolverines, Michigan, FIFA World Cup.
Goal.
Qatar.
Goal.
World Cup. VAR, USMTNC, World Cup, Wordle. I got lots on it.
Mornings with Sharp and Hanley, the Connor Happer Show, Unsportsmanlike Conduct, 6A to 6P, 1620, The Zone. Your Omaha area forecast from the Godfather's Pizza Weather Center and KETV News Watch 7 on 1620, The Zone.
Mostly sunny skies and a little bit of haze for your Thursday afternoon with a high today in Omaha of 62 and southerly winds up to about 10 miles an hour. Increasing clouds this evening and tonight. Still fairly mild though with a low by tomorrow morning of 42. Partly to mostly cloudy to end your work week. High on Friday, 68. I'm meteorologist Caitlin Harvey with KUTV News Watch 7.
1620 The Zone's Unsportsmanlike Conduct brought to you by a great friend of the program, Union Bank and Trust.
At Sid Dillon Chevrolet, we want you to have the best car buying experience possible. Shop Nebraska's number one volume Chevy dealer group or at siddillonchevy.com. Together, let's drive.
You are what drives us, Sid Dillon.
Trees, are they all the same? Not at Lanaha. Grown from a quality seed source, handcrafted in our local farms for generations, and acclimated to our tough Midwestern climate, Lanaha's trees are different. Simply put, they're better. Much like our trees, we take great pride in being homegrown. Visit our garden center to find your next tree today. Rooted in quality, unmatched value, Lanaha Nurseries, 192nd and Center.
Lindley Clothing in Omaha has been the premier provider of men's fashion for over 88 years, from suits to jeans, with great brands like Jack Victor, Bugatti, Peter Millar. Your father was a customer. You're a customer. Your son is a customer, and now they're looking for the latest sportswear to tailored clothing. Lindley Clothing has you covered. They will help you get the look that you need with their selection and top-notch customer service. You walk in the door, and there's John and Marlene and the entire Lindley Clothing team with a great smile on their face and there to help you. 132nd and West Dodge in Linden Market to pick up the latest styles and enjoy easy access shopping.
Na 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 na, hey, goodbye to busted brackets. Right now, FanDuel is going to let you bet on every game of the tournament. Whether you're betting on a big upset or a one seed, and they do get upset, it's time to go dancing on America's number one sports book. Because right now, Nick, new customers, we're looking at you. You can get $200 in bonus bets if your first $5 bet wins.
That's right. And we're in the Sweet 16. We don't want to hear about your busted bracket anymore. Make good on that. That's $200 to use on point spreads, money lines. You can even pick who's going to win it all. Just visit FanDuel.com, promo code zone. That's FanDuel.com/zone. And bet on college hoops until they cut down the nets. 21 plus and present in Iowa. First online real money wager only. $10 first deposit required. Bonus issued as non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-BETS-OFF.
Sometimes life throws you a curveball and you need a solution fast. A solution to help you make payroll, to save your house, to keep growing, or fund a startup, to fix a roof or other major repair. Sol's is your fast, local, confidential solution. Get the cash you need today with Sol's.
Maverick baseball and softball are underway, and single game tickets are on sale now. This Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, the weather is perfect as Maverick baseball takes on 2023 CWS qualifier Oral Roberts at Tal Anderson Field. Omaha softball is on a 15-game win streak and plays Creighton on April 2nd, and Maverick baseball takes on Creighton on April 9th. Don't miss these classic matchups at Maverick Park. Get your tickets now by calling 402-554-MAVS or by going to omavs.com/tix.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential, but finding those people can be a major hassle unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze, and right now you can try it for free at ziprecruiter.com/radio. With ZipRecruiter, one click sends your job to hundreds of top job sites. But more than that, ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies the candidates with the skills you need, sends you a list of great matches to review, then actively invites them to apply for your job. And the results speak for themselves. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. That's right, the first day. Now you can focus on your business and let ZipRecruiter do the work finding the best people for you. See for yourself. Experience the ease, efficiency, and power of ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/radio. That's ZipRecruiter.com/radio. ZipRecruiter.com/radio.
This edition of Unsportsmanlike Conduct on 1620 The Zone is proudly presented by Union Bank and Trust. The program starts now.
KOZN. Unsportsmanlike Conduct on 1620 The Zone. Husker Athletics, Creighton, and yes, UNO. Don't miss a moment, they'll give you your fix. They're on every day from 2 until 6. Spend your afternoons with John, Josh, and Nick. John, Josh, and Nick.
Oh my goodness, Connor Happer, what would it say if a guy hit a home run but was called a bust like 2 weeks ago? How would you describe that?
Incorrect. Bad take, especially in his first at bat of the season.
Of the entire season. Yeah, Mike Trout just had a dong.
Sportsmanlike Conduct on 1620 The Zone. Husker Athletics, Creighton, and yes,
welcome in, everybody, live from Stadium Swim here at Circa Sports. We appreciate you joining us on this Thursday afternoon, hour number 5 for us of 7, or no, How many hours? 7 hours?
Well, this is five of seven.
This is five of seven. Okay, that just seemed wrong for a second.
Yeah, it did. I was going to say it's hour four and a half.
Yeah, but it will be the fifth hour of the show. Yeah. All right, we're off to a great start. Welcome in, though. It's on Sportsmanlike Conduct here on 1620 The Zone. 1620thezone.com, the 1620 The Zone app, and of course, 1620 The Zone TV. Happer and I have traded places. I think that this was a good idea.
Let's go Royals.
Because now I can look at my computer and Happer can just talk about the Royals all the time.
I'll be watching the Royals. I'm in a better position to watch the Royals as well. It started at the top of the hour here. The first home run of the season, like you mentioned, Josh, goes to one and only Mike Trout.
Some people say he's a bust.
What a day for Nick. We get to say that Jimmy Allen was incredibly wrong
because
he hit the one home run. And Nick Grimm going the other way, zagging on the Angels. He says they're going to be good without Shohei.
I do.
And they have a 1-0 lead in the bottom of the first against a team that everybody thinks is going to win the World Series this year in the Baltimore Orioles.
Oh, that wasn't a part of our baseball segment earlier. I didn't realize people thought they were going to win the World Series.
I don't know. They're going to be good.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, people think they're going to be real good.
Speaking of good, we're going to be good today. Time for the Grum Down, brought to you by the Rooferies at John Higgins Weather Guard. We're going to have a guest join us live in just a few minutes, Mike Palm from right here at Circa.
Mike Palm.
He is the Vice President of Operations for a few casinos, including Circa. So we'll talk about that with Mike in a few minutes. The lines, the games, maybe who he likes tonight and tomorrow, and certainly, Happer just is asking everybody about Creighton. Hey, what do you think of Creighton? Hey,
I just talked to the guy from Lexington.
You went and talked to another guy who's not of Creighton about Creighton?
He asked me about Creighton.
Oh, okay.
I razzed him about Kentucky because I was in Pittsburgh last weekend.
Tough luck.
That town was taken over by Kentucky fans. Ugh. And then on Saturday, it was the looking around, John Travolta, Pulp Fiction, looking around. Where are these people?
Great meme.
They were not there anymore because they were eliminated by Jack Golke.
Do you think that's how Memphis felt about Nebraska fans? Like, oh my gosh, this is going to be great. They're going to be here all weekend long.
Yep.
And then they left.
Their poor economy.
Yeah, indeed. So Mike will join us in a few minutes. We'll also have Robin Washington. He'll join us at the bottom of next hour at 3:30. And a variety of things that we can talk about with Robin, including the sad end of the Nebraska basketball season and more with him. And then certainly room for you as well, whether it's giving us a call at 402-951-1620. Or texting us. You can shoot us a text at 402-951-1620. That's what Pedro did on the 42 Degrees The Source Hotline, Happer. Please have part of these shows as a Christmas show. Need the Vegas vacation, guys, for a cold winter day. When we have a foot of snow in Omaha, I can relive these shows.
That's a great idea. I like the prospect of that, considering our 4th of July messages this year that go out on Twitter will be, you know, if you want to just get a little taste of summer in here. It's not bad looking at us with all the, the floral shirts. And
you should do that. You should go into the pool when we're off of the Grum. You'd be like, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Okay, yes.
Okay, that's a great idea.
Yeah.
All right, awesome. We will do that.
Yep.
We'll do that after the show. You can also email us into the Equitable Bank inbox, Josh at 1620thezone.com, Connor at 1620thezone.com, or Nick at 1620thezone.com. We take banking personally at Equitable Bank. .com or on the JTech Construction Zone Twitter feed at USC1620. And don't forget, follow at 1620 The Zone. It's not just retweets now. There are graphics, there are schedules,
there's things,
there's videos,
many things, videos,
Nick's vlogs,
and a whole lot more. You can find all of that on the JTech Construction Zone Twitter feed. Some other things that we can get into today. I have a Creighton-related question for you. Still trying to decide, are we saving that for today or saving that for tomorrow, given that the Blue Jays will play tomorrow night?
Well, we still have Topic Alert.
We still have Topic Alert.
All of the Topic Alerts.
Topic Alert.
Man, we should dive into that.
We'll
do that later this hour.
We still have things of sports we have to show Nick.
We do.
That's good, too.
Along with that, we have audio from John Bishop. He had a chance to talk to Marcus Blossom, a bit of a preview of his of the 1620 The Jays podcast this week. He had a longer conversation, but we'll have a shorter interview to air with him, and then some other Creighton takes as well. I mean, gosh, we just have so many things.
I know.
So many things. So when we return, though, Mike Palm is going to join us live here at Stadium. We are at Circa Resort and Casino in Las Vegas having an absolutely awesome time. We appreciate Circa for having us out. And we appreciate everyone here at Stadium Swim hooking us up with the very comfortable cabana. There was a listener earlier who asked Nick for a tour. Friend, Nick has a tour coming your way.
Wow.
Coming your way, a part of the vlog.
Watch the vlog.
And also in that, Nick in the battle with the microphone and the headset.
We'll see.
Nick versus microphone.
Does it sound okay right now?
You sound fine, Nick.
Okay.
You sound fine. Mike Palm, though, when we return, it is Unsportsmanlike Conduct on this Thursday, live from Circa Resort and Casino in Las Vegas on 1620 The Zone.
You know, sometimes a small gesture can lead to the biggest reward. And one small gesture you could give is check that box next to the organ and tissue donor section next time you renew your hunting, driver's, or fishing license. John Bishop here for GoodGuysSaveLives.com. I know some of you may have some trepidation or misgivings or questions about organ and tissue donation. Well, let me assure you that it doesn't cost anything to you or your family. Also, you can be at any stage of age or health and still be a registered donor. Plus, most traditional funeral practices can still be followed with a successful donation. Tissue donation can lead to faster recovery from sports injuries or skin grafts from those who have suffered accidents or burn victims, or donated corneas give the gift of sight. So next time you renew your driver's, hunting, or fishing license, check that organ and tissue donor box or visit GoodGuysSaveLives.com. Save up to 8 lives at GoodGuysSaveLives.com.
Big names, big games. We've got them all. 1620, The Zone.
There's no need to hunt for the prize eggs. They're waiting for you at the 42 Degrees Easter Sale. Hop on in and fill your basket with drastically reduced prices on premium cannabis, CBD, Delta, premium Kratom, American Glass up to 50% off, and disposables up to 75% off. The Easter Sale at 42 Degrees, your destination for top-tier cannabis, second-to-none product selection, and exceptional service. 42 Degrees, by your mom's house.
Looking for a sweet treat that will transport you back into time? Look no further than Ted and Wally's. With two convenient locations in Benson and the Old Market, it's the perfect place to satisfy your cravings. Whether you're downtown or in Benson, make sure to stop in. And if you're catching a basketball game, why not indulge in a delicious dessert afterwards? With over 3,000 flavors to choose from, there's something for everyone. Don't forget to check out our social media for daily flavors. Ted and Wally's, serving up nostalgia at its finest for over 35 years. Visit TedandWally's.com for more information.
When I heard the words, you have breast cancer, I said, I have no idea what I'm gonna do. My OBGYN called me and said, I know exactly what we're gonna do, which led me to Nebraska Cancer Specialists. From day one, I felt that I was at the right place. There were some pretty rough times, but together we are stronger and they are there for you. You do not feel that you are alone.
NebraskaCancer.com.
Maverick baseball and softball are underway, and single game tickets are on sale now. This Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, the weather is perfect as Maverick baseball takes on 2023 CWS qualifier Oral Roberts at Tal Anderson Field. Omaha softball is on a 15-game win streak, plays Creighton on April 2nd, and Maverick baseball takes on Creighton on April 9th. Don't miss these classic matchups at Maverick Park. Get your tickets now by calling 402-554-MAVS or by going to omavs.com/tix.
A team succeeds when they work together. Banking's no different. At UBT, we're in your corner for every financial move you want to make. Your money's backed by a roster of experts who put in the work to know you and your community. So whether you're opening a savings account, buying a home, or planning your future, you always know who to turn to. Working together toward your financial goals, that's a win in our playbook. Union Bank and Trust, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
There are any number of reasons you might consider selling your home. To move closer to family, live within a smaller budget, or just wanting a change of scenery. Whatever your reasons, having to figure out all the various housing market trends in your area may not be what you signed up for. That's where an agent who is a realtor comes in. Realtors have the expertise to help you find the right price and navigate the process to sell your home in a way that's right for you. That's who we are. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors.
You're listening to Unsportsmanlike Conduct on 1620 The Zone.
Welcome back. It is Unsportsmanlike Conduct here on 1620 The Zone and 1620thezone.com. We are live at Stadium Swim at the Circa Resort and Casino in Las Vegas. Josh Peterson, Connor Happer with you on the program today. We got Nick Grimm with us, and we also have the VP of Operations at Circa with us today as well. It is Mike Palm who joins the program right now. Mike, thank you so much for taking the time. How are you?
Well, thank you for being here. I mean, this is a confluence of events here. Opening day, Sweet 16, Easter weekend. I mean, there's a lot going on here.
It's so good.
And by the way, the weather's like, you know, it's a Chamber of Commerce day here. So
it's perfect. A little, maybe a little windy. We brought the wind with us.
It's always windy.
Okay.
It's always windy here. Like the average day, the wind is like 25 miles an hour.
Oh, so yesterday we just got really lucky.
Yeah, this is just a vacuum the way it lays out.
Gotcha.
When we did a wind study when we built the place. And it was funny because, like, this area right in the center here is the windiest part of the deck. So we're just offset maybe, you know, what, 25 feet from it?
Right.
But, like, on an average day, they would show you. And it's a man reading a newspaper on a lawn chair, right? And this is 5 mile an hour. With it. And like, the average day here, he's, like, struggling to hold the paper to read it.
You were talking about, I mean, when you get the idea to build a place like this, because it's unlike, I mean, it's unlike anything we've ever seen.
Yes.
You know, it's pools, it's the sports watching experience. Like we see cool, like amusement parks around the country, whatever, you have screens all over the place. This one is for the sports fan. Like, where did the idea come from and how did it turn out in terms of how you expected it?
So when Derek bought the D in late 2011, he started in 2013, taking groups of employees every Sunday in the summer to different pools around town and observe what they liked and what they didn't like. And, you know, he's a big sports bettor, right? And he hated that, like, he couldn't hear the NBA finals or he couldn't hear the stadium.
Yeah.
Or just even a baseball game, right? You go to a pool, it's a great pool experience, but there's no sports interwoven into the fabric of it. So the design was set to mesh sports viewing with the day drinking experience as well, right? Because it's still DJ music 90% of the time, right? I think he had a little bit of a different idea about sports. And I'm like, who's coming at 10 a.m. in August?
You're a baseball announcer.
To listen to the Rays and the Orioles. Okay, Derek, please. So, I mean, we play the audio on NFL Sundays, you know, major games, stuff like that. When we do nights viewing parties, stuff like that. But it's mostly still a day drinking with sports in the background.
Mike Palm joining us right now, the VP of Operations at Circa. Mike, it was funny. As we're walking around yesterday, whether it's at the traditional book, whether it's out here, one of the things that I know that I have observed from afar before I got here, I love the look of everything. I love the classic with the modern and the way in which the sports book is and the way in which you get all the live lines or the live. I want to talk about, like, the idea to kind of have the look of everything and maybe why that was the decision, because I think it looks great.
Well, Circa is supposed to mean of a certain era, and he wanted to blend different eras, right? Still use modern technology, but have hints to some of the classic style. So we spent a lot of time just going to Brookings, South Dakota, and Daktronics and designing these boards.
Yeah, awesome. We love the boards.
The indoor board and the outdoor board, vastly different because you have to protect for weather. So they have, like, these louvers. You can't see them, but they stick out over every pixel to protect from mainly sun here, but also rain when it rains. And so the color of the readability of the screen, the font of the odds, all this stuff, and then designing it so that you can have one picture there. You can actually split it. So you have 8 on top, 3 in the middle, 8 on the bottom, like we do in the sport, all the different design. There's a garage door design and all that for the optimal viewing experience, depending on the timing and how the importance of, and how many different games are going on.
Man, fantastic. We sort of walked out onto Fremont Street last night too. And, like, you'll walk through and it certainly looks one way. And then you walk over here and you're like, whoa, this is sharp and clean. And it has all this stuff to it. And it I think it fits really well, but it also stands out just amongst your neighbors at the same time.
Well, the casinos on Fremont Street are all a collective. So you don't do any good in a way to try to take from your, like, if the design of this place was to bring all the Golden Nugget customers here, one, it wouldn't work, and two, it wouldn't make sense for the group. We're trying to draw people from the strip to come here. We're trying
cool.
to draw people from Summerlin to come here and spend a day either at the Booker Stadium Swim or maybe Legacy Club or come to eat at Barry's or 8 East. Sean McBurney, who's the president of Caesars now, was texting Derek last week. He's like, congrats. I hear you're having a great March Madness. And Derek said, well, what do you mean? You know, we were, but what do you mean? He says, like, all my valet guys say all the Uber rides are to Circa. Mm-hmm. Everybody's going down to Circa to watch the opening rounds of the tournament. So that's a great compliment.
Everybody sees this thing, and they look like, I mean, we see it around the country. We're in Nebraska. Like, we've heard of this place before we got involved with it. It's fantastic.
How we're talking right now with Mike Palm. How many games can you put on this? How many games can you put on the screen inside of the sports book?
So 19. I mean, but we have feeds for like 48 different events. But yeah. 19 at one time is generally the max that we go with. And I don't know if you have a chance to be here at night after sunset. And now it's obviously backed up with daylight saving. But the screen actually pops so well.
It does. We came here at night last night.
Like yeah. Thursday night football.
Yes.
Sunday night, Monday night. It's so sharp at night. And most people don't get the experience because they're here in the daytime. But it's a really cool venue at night. We've had concerts out here at night. And then the UFC cards on these Saturday nights are, you know, we get to capacity out here. We get, you know, 3,000 people here for the UFC is such a huge draw.
Do you get requests on stuff that, like, is ever not up? I don't know how you could miss one, but like something that's ever not up there.
Well, you know, somebody will be here and their niece is playing in a super regional in college softball, you know, and they want the game up and ESPN's got it on. And sometimes we can do it.
You give them a corner.
Yeah. Right. You get a little corner, yeah. Your little slice of heaven. And then I said, well, what about the sound? Are you pushed in?
Yeah, right. Too much.
If you want it your way, go to Burger King. You know, that's
exactly. You got your baseball jersey on, though.
Yeah, I was going to ask him about that.
Okay, so it's Cubs jersey. Greg Maddux, I know, was here this morning.
He threw out the opening pitch for us.
Incredible. Yep. So awesome. So you're I was scrolling through your Twitter account a little bit. You're like emotionally invested in baseball.
Oh, I love baseball. Yeah. I mean, I grew up playing baseball. My dad was a baseball manager, and I just love it. I mean, I could sit here and watch all these games all day long. I don't know if I could do that for basketball. You know, it's tough on these opening days. You sit through 12 hours of college basketball. I like betting the sport. I think they've done a lot of good things to speed it up. You know, we're the Netflix generation. We want it on demand, and people don't want to sit through 3-hour games. I think they've done a good job of doing that. I'm a little frustrated at this opening day schedule that they didn't have a backup plan for the early game.
I know.
You know, it used to be 2 games at 10 Pacific time. So for you guys, 2 games at noon, 2 games at 1, 2 games at 2.
Yeah.
Why all these 8 games at 1 o'clock and not playing in dome? So that's a little disappointing. And then, of course, they do it on the Sweet 16 day. You've got to own the day. There's a few days you can own. You could own this day. But I think the game's in a good place. I think the rule changes they've made have been very good over the years. I hope nothing happens with Shohei. The game needs Shohei.
No doubt.
Nothing comes out of that. I hope if he did bet on something that had nothing to do with Major League Baseball. He's painted himself into a thin corner.
Yes, he has.
He's never bet on any sport. And the story, I don't know how long.
He better be telling the truth.
I don't know how long it'll take to unravel this story, but the cover-up has been very clumsy, if there is one.
No doubt.
Certainly. Mike, before we let you go, you are wearing a Cubs jersey. The co-host of my show, he's in Detroit for Creighton basketball. So I know he'd want me to ask, how do you think they're going to do this year?
I bet over on the Cubs wins. I think the council move is more impactful than Bellinger. I don't think people really understood how important Bruce Bochy was going to be to the Rangers. I did bet them over their win total last year. I didn't bet them in playoff futures. I'm kicking myself.
Right.
Unfortunately, we went down last Friday. We flew down to see the Cubs-White Sox rookie game in Phoenix.
Yeah, the spring breakout.
It rained. Yeah, right. But it rained for 6 hours, and we couldn't wait around. I wanted to see Cade Henry pitch. But anyhow, they gave us a full tour because of our partnership with Marquee of all the facility. It's amazing how much of their workout and training routine council has changed. I think he will have a significant impact. So I'm over on Cubs again this year.
Interesting. All right. Well, Mike Palm, the VP of operations here at Circa. Mike, thank you so much for taking the time. Thank you for having us. We have had a wonderful experience. This is such a great view. Thanks again, and enjoy the baseball today.
Good luck to Creighton, a great Catholic school in Omaha, in the Sweet 16.
All right, thank you very much. That is Mike Palm, the VP of operations here at Circa. We have Robin Washer coming up at the bottom of the 3 o'clock hour, and more as well, as we are live here at the Circa Resort and Casino and Stadium Swim. Unsportsmanlike kind of continues next on 1620 The Zone.
Live from the Host Coffee Studio, this is 1620 The Zone. You know what mentality can help you with? Low energy, motivation, weight gain, muscle loss, fatigue, tired all the time, feeling anxious, moody, irritability, impatience, anxiety, and depression. Mentality can help you with their board-certified physicians and their testosterone treatments that can take care of you and get you back in the game. You can regain normal function and restore your ability to perform normally at all levels just by Mentality. Set up an appointment today. Go to lowtusa.com. Get back in the game. Don't sit on the sidelines and let Mentality lead the way.
Hi, friends. Kent Pavelka, courtside, getting ready for this year's matchup between the average roofing companies and the rooferies at John Higgins Weather Guard. The average roofers are just that, average at best, not very impressive. The rooferies, above and beyond the opponent. More dependable, service that exceeds the norm. Good sportsmanship, fairness, and integrity. You know them, you love them, and they're ready to win for you. Make the right call with John Higgins Weather Guard. It's tip-off time with the rooferies at John Higgins Weather Guard.
Make the right call!
At Union Bank, people don't have your money. Your money has people. First Home people, investment people, people people, people who answer the phone and your chats, dream car people, dream retirement people, driving your dream car in your dream retirement people, small business people, credit card people, and all the other people you need. At Union Bank, our people help you do more than you dreamed possible. So stop in and say hello. We can't wait to see you. Union Bank and Trust, member FDIC.
Hey everyone, Josh and John here for the FanDuel Sportsbook. Whether it is grand slams, no-hitters, or double plays, all of it's back with Major League Baseball, and there is no better place to get in on the MLB action than on FanDuel, America's number one sportsbook. Right now, new customers can start the Major League Baseball season with $200 in bonus bets. If your first bet of $5 wins, just go to FanDuel.com/1620 today and get in on the baseball action.
Oh, Josh, come on. Little more enthusiasm. Baseball is back, and new customers can start the MLB season with $200 in bonus bets if that first $5 bet wins. So visit FanDuel.com/1620 to join today and enjoy all of the excitement of Major League Baseball. 21 plus and present in Iowa. First online, real money wager only. $10 first deposit required. Bonus issued is non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-BETS-OFF.
What goes perfect with the madness of March? The convenience of Cubby's downtown in the Old Market, 13th and Jackson. And if you're gearing up to watch the game, Cubby's has what you need. You'll find a full meat counter with steaks, burgers, chicken, and homemade brats. Hot and fresh deli food, including Chester's Chicken and Godfather's Pizza Express. Pop, water, beer, and a full liquor department. See you at Cubby's Old Market, the very best in convenience. Open 24 hours at 13th and Jackson.
A DJ spinning songs, cheeseburgers, raffles, and more. Just a random Saturday? Nope. It's the Spring Open House at Les Hills Harley-Davidson. Come in, join the fun, and swing your leg over a genuine Harley-Davidson. I-29 at the Glenwood exit and at leshillshd.com.
Are you the decision maker in your company? Consider this. For the first time in decades, there's a better option for a corporate card and spend management platform. Meet Ramp, the only corporate card and spend management system designed to help you spend less money, so you can make more. Most corporate credit cards offer points as incentives, but those points amount to less than their worth in real cash value. Ramp's corporate cards offer you cash back, real money in your pocket. Plus, you control who spends what with each vendor. And Ramp's software collects and verifies receipts automatically, which means you'll stop wasteful spending and close your books in hours instead of days. Businesses that use Ramp add up to 5% to their bottom line the first year. If you're a decision maker, adding Ramp could be one of the best decisions you've ever made. And now get $250 when you join Ramp. Just go to ramp.com/sports. ramp.com/sports. ramp.com/sports.
Cards issued by Sutton Bank and Celtic Bank, members of FDIC. Terms and conditions apply.
Lindley Clothing in Omaha has been the premier provider of men's fashion for over 88 years, from suits to jeans, with great brands like Jack Victor, Bugatti, Peter Millar. Your father was a customer. You're a customer. Your son is a customer, and now they're looking for the latest sportswear to tailored clothing. Lindley Clothing has you covered. They will help you get the look that you need with their selection and top-notch customer service. You walk in the door, and there's John and Marlene and the entire Lindley Clothing team with a great smile on their face and there to help you. 132nd and West Dodge in Linden Market to pick up the latest styles and enjoy easy access shopping.
Tickets for less. Best seats, best prices, no service fees. Shop ticketsforless.com. KOZN Bellevue, Omaha, Council Bluffs. This is 1620 The Zone.
Josh Peterson, Connor Happer, Nick Grimm with you here at Circus Sports. Joey hanging out back at the Zone Studio in Omaha, and we appreciate you joining us on Unsportsmanlike Conduct. We were just talking about it with Mike Palm, just how baseball, it's so odd as always with the sport. They begin, first of all, overseas, and then the season has started, and yet the story is something else other than the actual baseball.
Yeah.
And then opening day happens. First of all, the early games
get rained out,
and then it's also Sweet 16 Thursday. It's like you know, sometimes I look at college football and I'll say, like, why in the world is the sport built in the way where we're talking about realignment?
Like, if they would have started
week one of the season,
if
you know,
baseball would have started on Tuesday this year, they would have been in great
shape. I was literally just thinking to myself, why didn't they start 2 days ago? There's no basketball, there's nothing going on. They could have started, and instead, nope, not so much. So they'll get drowned out a little bit. But I know Nick is excited. Happer's excited.
The Royals are being introduced right now.
James asked, is there a small TV in the cabana?
There is.
It ain't small, though. It's a normal-sized, large TV.
That TV be TV.
Yeah. So you can watch whatever you want on that TV, and then you could watch whatever you want on all of the TVs in front of us.
You want me to look for the Royals game on this TV for you, Happer?
I would love that, actually, yes.
All right, awesome.
Because here's another thing that I hadn't really thought about until the conversation really kicked up this morning with opening day here. I'm going to have to confront my problem at home, which is I don't have the Royals. I don't have access to the Royals at the moment.
Yeah.
I might have to buy a Bally.
Oh, Bally boy.
I screwed up.
Yeah, not good.
I was wondering what you were going to do.
I haven't thought about it yet.
In regards to the baseball? Yeah. That
feels like something you should have thought about a little earlier.
Yeah. No, I don't need it yet.
The season is here.
I'm not here, Nick. I'm in Vegas.
The season is here. We are in Vegas. And one of the things that we asked for earlier from the fine friends of the Grump.
Was a hashtag topic alert. Wow, Nick.
What?
You sounded not excited about topic alert.
Topic alert.
Wow. So we have a lot of those. Also coming up in a few minutes, we'll have a report from John.
John Bishop.
From
guest
Detroit.
On his own show.
Guest on his own show. So that's coming up in our next segment. Also, Robin Washington at the bottom of the 3 o'clock hour. Do you want to start with sports or non-sports from the hashtag topic alert?
Sports.
Sports. Okay, perfect. How about this one about Jaden Daniels? Have you seen this? Have you heard about this? A photo was put out yesterday by Ian Rappaport.
Yep.
I'll just read the tweet. It has nothing to do with what we're going to talk about, but it says, immediately following his pro day, Jaden Daniels scheduled to meet with the Patriots, Commanders, Giants, Vikings, Broncos, Raiders. Per his agent, Daniels had not previously met with the teams. Well, Johnny Pig says, this can't be a real photo of Jaden Daniels' throwing arm, can it? And it's a close-up of his elbow. And I don't know what's going on with his elbow.
His elbow is jutting off of his body. And it doesn't look natural.
Some doctor responded with a very long tweet. Jesus is like a column. Dr. Jesse Morse.
Yeah. I do think, I don't know what that tweet from the doctor says.
He says he has bursitis.
That's a normal thing to have.
Okay.
Yeah, elbow bursitis.
His muscle. Look at his muscle. It's like
so weird.
Is this photoshopped? That's the question.
I don't think that looks particularly normal, but I will say that if you freeze frame anybody throwing something
really fast,
that is how it's going to look. This motion, the throwing of a football or a baseball motion, is not natural. This is why guys get Tommy John. This is why guys have arm injuries, because it's not normal. It's not good on your
elbow.
You're
not supposed to do that.
Your elbow doesn't work like that.
It doesn't go spinny.
Why don't we throw in a wave that our elbow's cool with?
Because that's softball.
Oh, fair.
That's softball. Your elbow loves that.
Not a whole lot of Tommy John's in softball.
Zero, in fact.
Isn't that crazy?
I don't think we've ever seen a Tommy John in softball.
Whole question, has there ever been a Tommy John in softball? So your thought on the photo, and I do think that I agree with you, It's
actually a normal thing to happen. It's just a picture in the wrong moment.
Because if you see a picture of track and field athletes during the Olympics, you'd say, whoa, what happened to Usain Bolt's legs? They go round. They're really round. It's like, no, that's just a photo of him running.
Yeah. Right.
Okay. So we agree on that one.
We do.
Hashtag topic alert. Thank you. Andrew writes, I like hearing the joy in your voices. Doing what you love and not missing John at all.
I love John.
I love John too.
I miss John. I wish John was here. I think we would have had so much fun if John was here.
Oh, it'd be incredible.
But I'm also really happy for John
that he gets to experience what he's about to experience tomorrow and potentially Sunday.
Yes, indeed. We are happy. We can be happy away and apart. Fondness and such, you know.
Absence makes the heart grow fonder.
That's what I was trying to say.
I know, yeah, you were trying to get there.
I got lost in the sauce.
By the way, Adley Rutschman just added a 2-RBI single, and the Orioles now lead 4-1 over Nick's Angels.
Wow. Ewing theory.
Jimmy Allen's Angels.
Ewing theory falling apart.
Hey, it's a long season. They still have 161 more games.
And a half. No, most of this one, actually. Dave says, which tropic is better, Cancer or Capricorn? Hashtag topic alert. Hashtag tropic alert.
Where are each of those located?
Nick?
I don't remember. What about the Tropic Thunder? How do we feel about that one?
The movie?
I love that movie.
We should watch that movie for Movie Club.
I agree. I wouldn't even need to watch it. I have seen it so many times.
I saw a couple years ago that TikTok was mad at Robert Downey Jr. and they wanted to cancel him.
Oh,
and it's
because
like,
of...
No, that's the bit. The bit is him wearing the blackface. Uh-huh. That is the whole bit of the movie.
Yeah, you can't cancel him for that.
No, you're not allowed. He almost won an Oscar for that.
He should have.
All right. Cancer versus Capricorn.
Capricorn. I'll do Capricorn.
All right. What are these again?
The Tropic of... Well, isn't that just...
Oh,
a,
that's right. The Tropic of...
Isn't that just like a line of longitude, latitude?
I think you might
latitude
be
is lateral. Longitude is the long
I think I'm going to be a Tropic of Cancer person because that's in the Northern Hemisphere, which is where America is. So give me, give me the Tropic of Cancer.
America first.
The
Josh.
Tropic of Capricorn lies at the 23rd... 26, 22, 23, whatever degrees south of the equator, and marks the most southerly latitude at which the sun can appear directly overhead at noon.
I was trying to remember what the bit was for the tropics.
This event occurs at the December solstice when the southern hemisphere is tilted toward the sun to its maximum extent.
So how long of a day do they have then in the in the tropics?
The Tropic of Capricorn is significant to understanding the Earth's geography because it marks the southern boundary of tropics.
Oh, okay. There you go. Charles says pro Capricorn.
This is the region that extends from the equator south to the Tropic of Capricorn and north to the Tropic of Cancer. Wow.
So there you go.
I vote Capricorn. Wow. I'm Team South.
Team South. The South will rise again.
Wow. You both want the South to do really well today.
I like it warm. I like it warm.
Why was I into the South earlier again?
I don't remember.
All right.
No, baseball.
Are we in the South at the moment?
Poll question.
We are.
Is Las Vegas the South?
It is South.
Las Vegas is not
it's
South.
Southwest.
It is south of Omaha.
It is. Southwest is what they call this.
It's really weird when you think about it like that.
Taylor asks, I believe this is for a hashtag topic alert. How many frozen daiquiris will it take for Connor to lose his lunch?
Our daiquiri friend isn't here today.
Well, I mean, he might be. Oh, you guys have been. I need to go to the bathroom.
Who asked that question about frozen daiquiris?
That was Taylor.
Okay. All right, good. Well, first of all, I haven't had any lunch.
No, we have not. We had breakfast.
No. So, and I haven't had any frozen daiquiris, so that's going to be a problem. I will say that did not hit me the right way yesterday. We were coming off a long day of travel.
You said that. You were like, Nick, you can have this.
When things are overly sweet, bomb you with sweetness,
yeah,
that's a tough hang for me.
That's like when I go to a place that
I need someone with a little bite. Just give me I might go up to the bar and get a Modelo.
That's why I like margaritas that are more on the tart side or cut with like jalapenos.
Yes.
Because I don't want just the sugary garbage.
Charles asked, how many daiquiris will it take for Happer to deliver on his nipple promise?
Oh, no, that's a
people want to see your nips.
Yeah.
You got
it's getting hot.
Nips.
I don't think that has anything to do with daiquiris. I'll tell you what. When the Royals score their first run, in the pool.
Let's go.
I'm in the pool. When the Royals score their
first...
I was in the pool!
You need to warn me before that. That's a vlog contest.
When the Royals score their first run, I am in the pool. If they do not score a run today, there will be no nipples for the stream.
Chris in Montana says, topic alert, Caitlin Clark burnout. Is Caitlin Clark being offered $5 million for Ice Cube's 3-on-3 league one of the most ridiculous things you've ever heard?
Yes. It's just a publicity thing from
Ice
Cube.
Total publicity.
And then the Portnoy Barstool guy was like, I'll give her $10 million
to
do
what?
I don't know. To be on Barstool's intramural team or something like that?
Yeah, see, these are all just bits.
Yeah.
Come up with better bits.
It's really okay. We don't have to pay attention to this.
We don't. Like, it's not a big deal.
It's okay. Caitlin Clark is going to get offered a lot of money to do a lot of things. She won't do a lot of them.
Yes.
And we don't have to care about it.
There you go.
That's the way you should approach this, I think.
That's talking Caitlin Clark. We did the one from Declan earlier, right? About the quarterback situation. Riley said get ready to see Dylan Raiola or Dylan Thicola. Here's another one from Declan. Hashtag topic alert.
5-1 Orioles, by the way. Anthony Santander, sack fly.
Wow.
Santander.
Do you know these names just like by knowing them? Like,
no, I know most of the baseball players.
So they didn't show up a graphic. You just saw the number and you're like, oh, that's Bobby Timmy.
I mean, they have names on the back of their jerseys.
They do, except unless you're the Yankees.
Nice.
I have been learning baseball player names just by osmosis. Yep. And I understand how Happer can play things like Immaculate Grid and just know baseball players now. Because I'll just be like, oh, yeah.
I don't.
Like, I'll just hear a name, like, oh, that guy's on the Padres.
I'm
know that now.
Better about that in 2001. You give me his 2001 name, and I got
Josh
you, man.
Here for 2001 again.
Yeah, yeah. Is Bunyoung Kim?
Bunyoung Kim, what about him?
What about is that it? Is that the only
no.
other 2001
He
player?
Would be a bad grid answer, because I'm pretty sure he only played for the Diamondbacks.
Yeah, because he melted down in the World Series that year. No, I can name a lot of other players from the 2001 era of Major
Derek
League
Jeter
baseball.
Was Scott
there. Brocious.
Jeter, Scott Brocious.
Tino Martinez.
Let's see. Ted Youkilis. He played baseball in 01, right? Manny Ramirez. I David Ortiz.
Ted Youkilis was definitely his name.
Tim Youkilis.
Kevin Youkilis.
Is there not a Tim Youkilis?
No.
All right. Well, I said Youkilis.
Was the Elder Holiday, was he in 2001 yet?
Ryan Halliday?
Yeah.
Matt Holiday. You're talking about?
Ryan. Oh, is Ryan the one playing now?
There is no Ryan Holiday.
Really? Who's the baseball player who died in the crash? Who is that?
That was Roy Halladay.
Started with an R, though.
Roy Halladay, not related to Jackson
Ryan,
or Matt Holliday.
Roy Halladay. I was way off. Started
Holidays.
With an R, though.
And Halladay.
Anyway, Declan asks, what was your most recent adulting accomplishment? Mine was being complimented for buying shredded wheat cereal by the old man cashier.
For Nick, it was getting to Vegas in one piece,
I think. Yeah. Genuinely, it was.
Yeah. That felt like a big step for you.
Or my car. My new truck.
Oh, that's good.
That was a big step,
God,
too.
I'm trying to think of the most recent thing that
I've
did.
I've been an adult.
Look at you, Nick. I mean, I've kept my receipts, but that's more of a selfish thing, right? I want to get reimbursed, so I kept the receipts.
I forgot to get a receipt one time so far.
Already?
Yeah.
Where at? Which one?
The burger.
Wow, that's a big one.
Yeah.
You forgot the receipt at the first place?
I forgot the burger. It wasn't the first place, but
I mean,
forgot the burger receipt.
Basically just copy and paste our receipts.
No, I know. That's what I'm going to do.
Okay. Well, let's cut this out of the podcast so nobody knows. look, I had an alarm this morning, and I actually got up when the alarm went off, even though I didn't want to. I wanted to go back to sleep, even though I got close to a solid 8 hours. Mm. But I was like, I am so tired. But I got up, and I powered through, and I'm very happy that I did. Because if I would have delayed the run, and I'm happy that I did what I did.
My Congrats. Adulting thing has been drinking coffee lately. I've taken every opportunity to get a coffee.
You had some this morning.
Yeah.
We were enjoying coffee.
Yeah. Have you hit your year anniversary? You haven't hit your year anniversary of coffee yet,
I don't think
you?
We're even close.
Coffee-versary?
No, this is new for me.
Coffee-versary.
This has probably started around like the first of the year or maybe Christmas or something like that.
Oh, okay.
Somewhere around there.
Douglas writes, this is Angry Douglas, the basketball Douglas.
Mad Doug.
Baseball is is Greek to me. Listening to someone spout baseball names and stats is like listening to someone talk about horse racing at that level.
And so he loves it. That's what he's saying.
Doug, you are comparing way too many things. Say, if it's like Greek, say it's like a foreign language. Not, it's also like horse racing. I don't know what that means.
Point.
What are you doing?
If it's like Greek, what do you actually know about horse racing?
Nick, what's Doug's bid again? That he's at work, and so it's hard for him to type.
Yeah, I think so.
Man,
what
were you gonna say?
Oh, he's also anti-soccer stadium.
That's right. Yeah, this guy called in and he was like, do not put a soccer stadium in Omaha. I don't want to drive from West Omaha.
Yeah, just because it's not good for you doesn't mean it's not good.
Yeah. Husker Country says
we have to say that to Dion, too.
Yes.
Dion, some people do like Creighton.
Yeah, they do.
I know it's hard to believe, but you do not represent everybody's thoughts.
That's correct. Dion is not their purveyor of opinions.
No.
Husker Country says go back out in the sun. It was fun to people watch while you guys talked. Did you ever go back and look?
I did.
Could you see?
You could.
Oh, man.
There was a screenshot.
That someone tweeted at us?
No, you're talking about the first thing that happened with the person who was giving us waters yesterday.
Yeah. I'm talking
about the other thing.
The two people.
Oh, that thing.
Those very nice ladies.
It's not quite as clear.
Yes.
But it was
you could see what was kind of happening.
The funniest moment so far of this trip was that, I would say. I would say that it's that. Kenneth writes, Vegas pro tip, especially at Circa, sit down at the main bar left of the sports book, put 20 in the blackjack machine, play $1 hands, order drink, enjoy free drink.
Yeah.
We taught Nick about this. We said, what are we watching, Nick?
I hit the wrong button.
Why is the baseball
Why'd you
gone?
Turn the Royals off?
The Royals weren't on.
Yeah, we never got the Royals on.
Get the Royals on.
That's what I was looking for.
They don't have it. No, Nick, go back up. Go back up so we can watch the base.
No, I know that's what I was thinking.
Yeah, so we told Nick about this. About one of the fun place things about Vegas is if you are playing one of their many games and someone comes and asks for a drink, you're good to go.
It's a totally different mindset. Like you just have to understand that they're trying to give you alcohol for free.
Yep.
They're trying to actually give you a lot of stuff for free just so that you stay here.
Yep.
That's the point of the whole thing.
I have never been more excited to get free beer in my life. It's cool. It's free beer.
Now, you should have been like, can I get free rice with this too?
And that's the point. Like, it gets you to the point where you don't understand how much money you're spending to get the free beer, which in Nick's case was a whole bunch of rice. He just gave the dealer rice last night, and she said, I cannot accept this.
Just emptied my pockets.
You cannot accept this.
And then he played the weird kitty cat blackjack game.
Flounder wants to know, along those lines, how did Nick perform at the tables last night?
How did you perform at the tables?
Kitty cat blackjack is confusing.
Look, we all did bad last night.
I did not like kitty cat blackjack.
I didn't either. I struggled at craps.
I don't remember if I mentioned this on the air earlier. So when I arrived and I did what you're supposed to do with craps, which is you wait for the roll to finish. Well, it was perfect because it was like, craps out 7. I was like, sweet, time for me to play. So I plunked down a few dollars, and the guy, he rolled a 4 as the point. And I'm like, well, this is a bummer. 4's probably not hitting. Ended up losing that. And then everybody left because the table was suddenly cold. Everybody left. So it was that guy, it was another guy, and it was me. Well, because the dice were going clockwise around the table, it was suddenly my turn. Over the course of 3 minutes, I probably rolled 15 times. My first roll being an 8, I'm like, 8, this is great. What an awesome point to start with. Ended up rolling a lot of numbers, including 2 9s, a 12, and something else, and then I crapped out as a 7. I was like, I'm done now playing craps for the
night.
That's
how it goes. And Mike, by the way, writes in, he says, as a problem gambling treatment professional, those drinks are definitely not
free.
They
are not free.
We know that. We are aware. You're paying for it in a just indirect way. By the way, they put up the Padres game. It looks beautiful in San Diego.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
This is the thing about opening day. The colors. It's during the day, like everybody comes out wearing their.
Again, you're just describing things about a television that like, you like
so
about baseball.
Cool.
I love baseball because people get in line like they're school children.
Josh,
first pitch.
How can you not be romantic about baseball?
It's very easy not to be romantic about baseball.
And the Royals are going to start playing baseball in 4 minutes, and then we're on
Nipple watch.
Tarps off for Bobby.
One more comment before we go to John Bishop from Detroit. Patrick says, you can drop your bet from pass to don't pass. See, Patrick, that's a horrible, mean move. I don't care if the odds are better. I'm not going to bet on the don't pass line. I'm not going to bet with the house.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You're betting with the house. You're betting against the table.
Oh, that'd be horrible.
Yeah, it's not fun.
You get booed.
It sounds like you're speaking Greek to me. It's like you're explaining horse racing right now.
I believe you get your ass kicked saying something like that, Josh.
It's like you're speaking kitty cat to me.
Not like kitty cat.
Yeah, indeed. Nobody did. All right. Any more topic alerts? Let us know for tomorrow.
Hashtag topic alert.
We can get those. A reminder, by the way, speaking of tomorrow, but also speaking of tonight, there are more college basketball playoff games. Those are now 3 hours from this exact minute from starting. There is a game tonight at 4:07, or if you're in the central time zone, 6:07. That's coming up tonight. And you can go to 1620thezone.com right now to make your picks in the college basketball playoff. Look, I don't think that you'll be able to win the grand prize given that you missed the entire first weekend, but you never know.
Point.
You never know. Maybe you get every pick right after that, so maybe you could win. Just go to 1620thezone.com right now. Still to come in this hour, Robin Washett will join us at 3:30. We'll talk with him. We have so many things still that we had planned to get to. We'll see if we can, including some unsportsmanlike content.
There's always 7 more hours tomorrow.
There's always 7 more hours tomorrow. But up next, John is in Detroit, and he had a chance to I don't know, mosey around, ask some questions.
Well, when you're there, you talk to people, you see what they're up to, and John found some interesting people to talk to.
He found some people, so we'll go to John and the people when we return from Detroit, Michigan. We are here at the Circuit Resort and Casino and Stadium Swim. We have baseball on. We'll have basketball on later. We have hockey on for some reason.
Nipples will be out.
And Happer's nipples. I don't know if those will be on the big screen, but they will be out, we hope, unless the Royals get shut out today.
I am hoping for the Royals to win today.
We all are, because you're not only are the nips coming out, but
Nick,
Happer's
you
gonna...
can talk actively about how you bet on the Royals.
I bet on the Royals.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we got to talk about Nick's bets. Yeah, we got to do that
Nick,
as well.
Nick calls it micro betting.
It was very funny. It was very funny. How did you describe the Michael Jackson people?
Microtransactions for street performance.
That was very funny. Nick's getting funnier.
Cole Reagans is about to throw the first pitch of his Cy Young campaign.
And sadly, we're going to break. John Bishop next on 1620 The Zone.
The Connor Happer Show.
Basketball is better than football. It's time to finally admit it to ourselves. The state has brainwashed you for years and years and years. Football this, football this. We have to talk about all these football topics. Who's going to be the fourth string running back this year? I'll never know. Does it matter? No, it doesn't. You ever notice how we're so happy right now and we haven't talked about football in weeks, Josh? Weeks.
The Connor Happer Show, weekdays from 10 to 2 on 1620 The Zone. Your Omaha area forecast from the Godfather's Pizza Weather Center and KETV News Watch 7 on 1620 The Zone.
Mostly sunny skies and a little bit of haze for your Thursday afternoon, with a high today in Omaha of 62 and southerly winds up to about 10 miles an hour. Increasing clouds this evening and tonight. Still fairly mild, though, with a low by tomorrow morning of 42. Partly to mostly cloudy to end your work week. High on Friday, 68. I'm meteorologist Caitlin Harvey with KUTV News Watch 7.
1620 The Zone's Unsportsmanlike Conduct, brought to you by a great friend of the program, Union Bank and Trust.
Corn, live in concert in Omaha. CHI Health Center, Friday, October 25th, with special guests Gojira and Spirit Box. Corn. Get tickets this Friday at 10 a.m. at Ticketmaster.com. For more, visit cornofficial.com.
It's Champions replacement window season, and we're celebrating with buy two windows, get two free. If your windows are drafty, difficult to operate, or costing you money on your energy bill, it's time to replace them. Champion Windows is here to help. Champion builds our own windows right here in the USA. We make the process easy. We help you choose the best design options for your home. We then build your project in our very own factory. Our install team manages your project every step of the way, and it's all backed by our lifetime guarantee. Turn your house into your dream home with more livable space in a new Champion sunroom, or enhance your curb appeal with new siding, now 30% off. Don't wait, this sale won't last long. Buy two windows, get two free, and 30% off sunrooms and siding. Call 877-GO-CHAMPION or visit championsavenow.com to schedule a free in-home estimate today. While discounts apply to our regular prices, select style supply, minimum purchase required. Cannot be combined with other advertised offers. See store or website for details.
Velocity Clinical Research in Omaha frequently conducts clinical trials for a broad range of investigational treatments. Typical studies involve medications for high cholesterol, diabetes, infectious diseases, acne, and others. Some current studies include low T, COPD, flu, pediatric, infant, and RSV. They also perform vaccine studies for people of all ages, conducting innovative research that has a positive impact online. See current trials at velocityclinicaltrials.com. Compensation for study-related time and travel. Find out more at velocityclinicaltrials.com.
How powerful is Cox Fiber? Powerful enough to let your band members in Vegas, Phoenix, and Omaha jam like you're all in the same garage. Introducing Cox Fiber, from the company with America's fastest download speeds. It's internet built for tomorrow, today. Cox, always building better. Analysis by Ookla speed test intelligence data. Fixed median download speeds. US Q3 2023. Limited availability in select areas. Speeds vary and are not guaranteed. Cox terms and other restrictions may apply.
Welcome to this episode of RV Ready, brought to you by Leach Camper Sales in Council Bluffs by Lake Manawa. Looks like the great outdoors is calling.
Thought I'd remind folks to head outside again.
Love that idea.
I know Leech Camper Sales has a great website.
LeechCamper.com.
Folks can browse the inventory and then head over to Leech Camper Sales in Council Bluffs and then head out to see me. And don't forget,
the coffee's always on.
Of course it is.
If you're looking for a safe and reliable vehicle to get you through all types of winter weather and more,
Baxter Subaru has you covered.
Symmetrical all-wheel drive comes standard on nearly all Subaru models and provides you better traction, improved stability, and maximized performance on wet and snowy roads.
So hop in the driver's seat of a new Outback, Forester, or Crosstrek now at Baxter Subaru Omaha. Shop our great sales and service deals now during the Subaru A Lot to Love event at BaxterSubaruOmaha.com.
Oddly, he's interesting because he's so uninteresting. He is the most uninteresting man in the world.
Hi, I'm Bob Berger. Don't settle for anyone more interesting. Let's get to work on your business and personal taxes, payroll and employee benefits, QuickBooks and retirement planning. Call me.
Call Berger, Elliott, and Pritchard CPAs at 402-551-1919 or visit bepcpa.com.
Hey, Omaha dog lovers. Get ready for more wags and more fun. Hound HQ, your dog's favorite spot for daycare, boarding, and top-notch grooming, is now open. At Hound HQ, there's plenty of space for a pup to sleep, play, and everything in between. Plus, our expert groomers are here to ensure your furry family member always looks fabulous. Join our pack on Facebook and Instagram at The Hound HQ, or visit our website, thehoundhq.com, and sign up your dog today. Hound HQ, more wags, more fun.
The Zone Hotline is powered by 42 Degrees. The Source. By your mom's house.
It's Unsportsmanlike Conduct.
Heavy package, heavy package.
On 1620 The Zone.
Hey, everyone. Back to Unsportsmanlike Conduct here on 1620 The Zone. John Bishop taking over here for just a little bit from Detroit. We are inside of Little Caesars Arena, where in a little over 24 hours, the Midwest region, Sweet 16, will get underway. Of course, the first game will be Purdue and Gonzaga, then followed by Creighton and Tennessee. We'll have all the coverage right here on 1620 The Zone after Unsportsmanlike Conduct, as tip-off scheduled for sometime around 9:30, whenever it may be. But either way, Nick Baugh and I will have you covered. We'll get back to the boys in the desert here in just a little bit, but here's a quick recap of some of the things that we heard today at Creighton's Media Day session. And things started off for Greg McDermott with a rather interesting question and answer. Of course, a lot of the talk around this year's NCAA tournament is the potential expansion down the road. Greg McDermott's answer might surprise a few folks.
Myron Metcalf, ESPN. Greg, it feels like the momentum is pushing us towards an expanded tournament. How do you feel about that? And if so, what should that look like if it happens?
You know, people aren't going to like what I have to say, but, you know, I'm probably in favor of expansion to a certain degree. And simply because last weekend is an incredible experience for every student athlete that gets to participate. So why are we only having 15% or 17% of our teams participate? Why not? I don't know what the number is. Is it 15? Is it 20? You know, somebody smarter than me will figure that out. But why not, in this world of student athlete welfare and doing more and more for student athletes, why not give more student athletes that experience? And I think most people that don't want the tournament messed with, it's for selfish reasons, because they like it the way it is. And that's not a good enough reason, in my opinion. If it's really about the student athletes, then give more opportunities for student athletes and that have had a good season. I think it includes more of the mid majors. This year was not necessarily a normal year, in that there were a lot of bid stealers. So I think more than, at least in recent history, there was a lot of teams left out that could win games in the tournament.
Can you give us at all a scouting report on Dalton Connect, and who do you think will match up with him? And with him and Baylor, do you think they're an example of what can be good out of the transfer portal? Maybe players that didn't have a lot of choices coming out of high school, they go to a smaller school, they take off, they go to a bigger school.
Yeah, I mean, they're both great stories of, you know, perseverance and a tremendous work ethic. And, you know, obviously they both had great years. You know, 2 years ago, you know, Dalton was at Northern Colorado and Baylor was at South Dakota State. And now you have a first team All-American and a third team All-American playing against each other in the Sweet 16. So, you know, unbelievable story. I don't know that you guard him with one guy. I think we have to give him different looks. And that's the plan. And, you know, hopefully take away his easy ones because he's going to make enough tough ones because he's an elite player. But, you know, he and Baylor, their journeys are similar in a lot of ways. And, you know, to watch their growth and development from, you know, when they were freshmen in college to where they are today is really a testament to their work ethic.
I'm wondering about kind of the other side of Baylor and Dalton's story is what the transfer portal has done, particularly in the tournament, but beyond, you know, when you see guys now, their team ends, they go into the portal, you know, in the first week or they don't make the tournament. I guess, what does that do for the game as a whole? I mean, is guys going up or guys going down?
You know, I'm all about the student athlete and them having choices. They deserve those choices. Could we do it at a different time? I wish we could. I would like the stories from Selection Sunday until Championship Monday to be about the teams in the NCAA tournament, not about who's leaving and who's joining this program. It's just unfortunate that that's such a big part of what's going on in the daily news, and I think it takes away from celebrating the teams that have had incredible years and have made it to this point. Is there a way to maneuver that time a little? I hope so, because it's very difficult. You know, my staff, while we're trying to prepare for Tennessee, my guys are also working the portal. You have to. And that's an unfortunate thing for a team that's in the tournament trying to advance, that you have to spend that amount of time, because if you don't make calls, then you're out. So, I don't like the timing of it, but, you know, I understand why it's there.
Abby Gallant, Creightonian, you guys have talked a lot about how the process has been really important to get you guys here. How important is it to continue to trust your process and your training as you're making this run?
Yeah, it's a great question. And it's, you know, that's what it's about. You know, we've talked about process all the way back to June, and trusting your work and being consistent with your daily habits. And if you do that, you'll be put in a position where you're going to have a chance. And even though it looked a little bleak late in that Oregon game, I think they never really had any self-doubt creep in because they put so much work in. Now, you can still put work in and the shot may not go in. But had that shot not go in, I would have still felt great about the shot Baylor got, because I've watched him practice that shot hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times. So he did the work, he prepared himself, and sometimes you're successful in those situations and sometimes you're not. But, you know, these guys believe in each other. They believe in their work. And, you know, that makes it for a pretty fun experience from a coaching perspective.
John Walker, Omaha World Herald. Mac, your initial takeaway was Tennessee's defense, obviously. Have you learned anything else about them since diving into the film throughout the week?
Yeah, you know, I've known Coach Barnes for a long time, and obviously coached against him when I was at Iowa State and he was at Texas. And interesting story. When Bruce Rasmussen called me and asked me to meet with him about the Creighton job when I was still at Iowa State, I still had a few years left of my contract at Iowa State. Creighton was still in the Valley, and I was meeting Bruce in Des Moines, 45 minute drive. When I got in my car and pulled out of my driveway, I called Rick Barnes. And because I had questions for him about that point in my career, this kind of move, and I hung up the phone with him when I pulled into the hotel parking lot 40 minutes later, and he just drilled me with questions and things to think about, short-term, long-term, that I think speaks to who Rick Barnes is. He's been a great friend of mine. I've always respected, you know, the way he's coached his teams and how he's gone about it. And this Tennessee team is, you know, it's got some of what he did offensively when he was at Texas, you know, trying to run some cutters off the basket, standard under the basket. I prepared for that before, and he does that a lot with Dalton. But defense standard there, that's really impressive with how they play. and how they compete and how disruptive they are every single play. And it can turn a game in a flash. So, you know, that message has been drilled into our guys over the course of the week. Whether we're ready for it, you know, we'll see. But Coach Barnes has done a great job with this program. It's been, you know, fun to watch him be as successful as he has been from afar.
Players were up next. And, of course, one of the big storylines in this matchup against the Tennessee Vols will be that both of the main star players, Baylor Shireman for Creighton and Dalton Connect of Tennessee, were both mid-major products either last year or 2 years ago. In fact, with Dalton Connect, he was only second team Big Sky a year ago at Northern Colorado and immediately elevated his game to SEC Player of the Year. And, of course, Baylor Shireman in his second year at Creighton was named to the first team All-Conference and was very close to being named the league's Player of the Year. So Baylor Shireman was asked about the matchup and the stories between himself and Dalton Connect.
Did you and Dalton Connect meet up at all on the AAU circuit or anything when you guys were coming up? And have you kind of followed his journey through Northern Colorado and all that?
Yeah, we never met on the AAU circuit. However, I had a buddy who went to Northern Colorado and was teammates with him in high school. But we don't know each other personally, but I do know, obviously, you know, he went to a smaller school like I did and then transferred up and has had a phenomenal season. So,
Baylor, kind of on that same note, how surreal is that the two All-Americans in this game are kind of transfer portal success stories?
Yeah, I mean, it just shows that, you know, you have to run your race. Everybody's different. You know, obviously I didn't have the high level offers coming out of high school right away, but, you know, I stayed down and trusted my work and ended up blessed to be in this position now. So,
Matty Arenas, White and Blue Review. For anybody, I'm curious what the difference is in the feeling and the prep and just the lead up to all of it, all the kind of the extra juice compared to this stage last year and going through it the first time together.
Ryan, want to take that first?
I think last year, you know, we're just a little extra excited about it, doing it for the first time. But, I mean, this year you got a little more experience, so you're still super excited about it, trying to take it all in. But it's almost easier to take it all in because you've been here before and you can take a step back easier.
Trey, want to add to that?
Yeah, kind of what Cobb said. You kind of know what to expect now, even though you're still very grateful to be. We know what the feeling is to be here, and we know what it takes to get the job done.
I'm just curious, what boxes you guys feel you need to check tomorrow to score effectively against a defense like Tennessee's?
Trey?
I would say just don't hold the ball too long. They're a very good team in terms of raking in the gaps and turning you over. So I think that we limit turnovers. We're able to get out in transition by getting stops like that. I think those are some of the boxes we have to check on the offensive end.
Ryan, anything else for you?
Yeah, same stuff Trey said. Just taking care of the ball, making sure we're getting shots and not turning it over. And, you know, that'll feed into our offense.
That'll wrap things up here from Little Caesars Arena. Again, Nick Baugh and I will have all your coverage tomorrow night as the Blue Jays take on the Tennessee Volunteers. Jimmy Allen and Alex Drake are also here in town, so we'll take care of you as far as the post-game coverage all right here. Late into the wee hours of early Saturday morning right here from the Motor City. We'll get back to Josh and Connor and Nick back at Circa Casino in Las Vegas right after this. It's Unsportsmanlike Conduct on your home for Creighton Blue Jay basketball, 1620 The Zone.
For the Jays, the Huskers, and even you Jayskers, we are 1620 The Zone.
Hi, this is Doug Nodgaard with Equitable Bank. Great service never goes out of style. When the digital age dawned, many said computers would be able to handle many of the interactions that used to take a person. Boy, were they wrong. How many times have you called your bank and gotten a recording to press 1 or 2? Not at Equitable. Not only does Equitable answer your call in the first ring, it's answered by a human being. That's because Equitable Bank values its customers. Equitable Bank, we take banking personally. Member FDIC.
There's no better thing than to help others in their time of need. John Bishop here to invite you to be an organ and tissue donor at goodguyssavelives.com. Anyone can register, regardless of age or medical condition. Donor hearts and lungs save lives. Donor tissue makes recovery from surgery easier. Next time you renew your license, check that organ and tissue donor box or visit goodguyssavelives.com. Learn more about organ donation today and see how you can save 8 lives at goodguyssavelives.com.
Not too long ago, I heard Jensen Tire and Auto guarantees if you find a tire they carry advertised by a local competitor at a lower price, they'll match it. I'm always looking for a great deal, so I thought I'd see for myself. Try as I might, I couldn't find a better price than at Jensen. So I bought my tires there, and guess what? They had the tires I wanted at the right price, and they had me in and out in no time. Sure, I'll always be on the lookout for a great deal, and if I happen to find one, I'm bringing it to Jensen, because I know they'll match it. Plus, I'll get their amazing customer service.
Hi, I'm Matt Jensen, president of Jensen Tire and Auto, inviting you to experience the difference at our locally owned and family-owned company. Check us out at JensenTireandAuto.com today.
Get ready for warm weather driving with early spring tire deals at Jensen. Save up to $200 on Goodyear, Cooper, General, Continental, Maxxis, and Kelly tires. Check out Jensen's early spring tire deals at JensenTireandAuto.com today.
What moves you? Whether it's running a race or playing with your grandkids, orthopedic specialists at CHI Health are dedicated to helping you keep life moving. We offer the latest surgical and non-surgical treatments, so you have options for painful shoulders, knees, hips, and every joint in between. Don't let joint pain put life on pause. Count on our team of orthopedic specialists to begin your journey back to what moves you today.
It's Champion's replacement window season, and we're celebrating with buy two windows, get two free. If your windows are drafty, difficult to operate, or costing you money on your energy bill, it's time to replace them. Champion Windows is here to help. Champion builds our own windows right here in the USA. We make the process easy. We help you choose the best design options for your home. We then build your project in our very own factory. Our install team manages your project every step of the way, and it's all backed by our lifetime guarantee. Turn your house into your dream home with more livable space in a new Champion sunroom, or enhance your curb appeal with new siding, now 30% off. Don't wait. This sale won't last long. Buy two windows, get two free, and 30% off sunrooms and siding. Call 877-GO-CHAMPION or visit championsavenow.com to schedule a free in-home estimate today. All discounts apply to our regular prices. Select styles apply. Minimum purchase required. Cannot be combined with other advertised offers. See store or website for details.
A team succeeds when they work together. Banking's no different. At UBT, we're in your corner for every financial move you want to make. Your money's backed by a roster of experts who put in the work to know you and your community. So whether you're opening a savings account, buying a home, or planning your future, you always know who to turn to. Working together toward your financial goals, that's a win in our playbook. Union Bank and Trust, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
How powerful is Cox Fiber? Powerful enough to let your band members in Vegas, Phoenix, and Omaha jam like you're all in the same garage. Introducing Cox Fiber from the company with America's fastest download speeds. It's internet built for tomorrow, today. Cox, always building better.
Analysis by Ookla speed test intelligence data. Fixed median download speeds. US Q3 2023. Limited availability in select areas. Speeds vary and are not guaranteed. Cox terms and the restrictions may apply.
1620 The Zone's unsportsmanlike conduct is brought to you by Union Bank and Trust. Now back to the program.
Robin Washit.
Blissful ignorance, I think, it could be an advantage here.
Robin Washit.
Yeah, I'm a ball guy. Yeah.
Yeah, it's going to be absolutely huge.
The hot take.
Washit. Washit's good.
Washit.
Yeah, Washit's real good.
Washit.
Washit's good.
Washit.
Yeah, real good.
Welcome back to Circa Resort and Casino and Stadium Swim here in sunny Las Vegas. Josh Peterson, Connor Haber, Nick Grimm with you here. Joey Colbert back in our Zone studios. And right now we go to the 42 Degrees, the Source Hotline. and welcome on from Husker Online our dear friend Robin Washit. Robin, how are you?
Doing well. Not as good as you guys, but I'm doing okay.
Yeah, probably not.
Wow.
I mean, I just jumped in the pool and Mikel Garcia hit a home run.
Uh-huh.
So, no, well, it's
you
okay.
That's all I care about. The fact that you got told for doing that. That's,
yeah, they blew the whistle on me. Nick, take it easy over there.
Nick, bro, that's so loud.
Let me go ahead and just shut that off for you.
There we go. Yeah, Nick, we've turned Nick's microphone off because it was very loud.
How was spring ball, Robin? Was it enthralling?
Yeah, it was you know, at least they had full pads on this time. It wasn't just helmets and jerseys, and guys were running around and throwing footballs and catching them. And it was about as good of a warm up as you're ever going to see in the history of college football. But no, it was good. Standard fare. It was good to get your first glimpse of quarterbacks, Ryola and Kalen in particular, and kind of see that picture of them on a practice field. Playing in Nebraska, so like it was just kind of that kind of introductory look at what this team, you know, is all about, and I guess we'll see how that translates over the course of the offseason.
Robin, what's it been like then having to throw yourself into football mode so quickly? I think a lot quicker than a lot of Husker fans were hoping that they would have to do the same, just given that, you know, a week ago at this time they hadn't even played in an NCAA tournament game.
Yeah, the transition's always difficult for me because, you know, I'm like full basketball mode and then have to start like dissecting the offensive line too deep and that sort of thing. So it takes me a little bit, but this year, like you mentioned, was a little bit harder of a shift than most just because they played longer than they have in a long time. They played one more game than we've seen in a while. So, yeah, I mean, it's a natural progression, but honestly, like, we've kind of had this conversation before, like, this spring football has been like the quietest start to a Nebraska spring that I can remember, like, ever. And a lot of that has to do with the success of men's basketball. Women's basketball had a lot to do with that. Certainly the athletic director storyline was a massive part in that. But like, the fact that spring football was like in third or maybe the fourth biggest headline around Nebraska athletics, I honestly think it's a good thing. I think it's for one, I think it's healthy for the fan base not to like completely dive headfirst into football season in March. You know, you can get to ease into it just a little bit more this year. But I think also for the football team to just kind of, you know, not, especially with the whole Ryola storyline, like if there was nothing else happening with Nebraska, like that spotlight would be significant, you know, from the time before he even had his first practice. So at least now, like, there's a little bit of a dip in your toe in period that I think they got to have. And I think that was good for the fan base. I think it was good for the football team.
Yeah, I think we'll be probably ready to go by the time the spring game rolls around. But for now, it's still a little bit of a hangover.
The conversation changes quickly.
Exactly. For now, it's still a little bit of a hangover from hoops. Speaking of, Robin, I wanted to get your thoughts on the activity in the portal for Nebraska basketball so far. Like, what's been your read on that? Obviously, it's varying levels of importance of losing guys with Wilcher and Kata, and there's the weird situation with Lloyd. Like, how do you read into the portal entries for Nebraska, knowing that they're going to do some work and get some guys coming back in on the other side?
Yeah, I don't know if any of the four departures so far were like stunning developments. I'd say probably biggest surprise, just because like you saw an opportunity for him to come back again with TJ Wilcher. But in the grand scheme of things, like, you know, he's been here for 3 years and, you know, really has kind of been the same guy. I thought he elevated his game for a while this year, where he looked like he was a potential front runner for Big Ten Sixth Man of the Year. But, you know, I think the feeling kind of is what it is within here. So with Nebraska wanting to upgrade its roster, with CJ probably looking to maybe take that next step in his career and get back to being a full-time starter, and, you know, what other motives he might have, it makes sense. It's disappointing, I know, because he was a fan favorite in a lot of ways. So that's just kind of the nature of the portal. But from a basketball standpoint, it wasn't a total shock. Eli Rice was a bit disappointing, just in the sense that they were really high on him and he showed some flashes. as a true freshman, of, you know, the type of player that he could develop into. But again, that's just kind of the nature of the beast these days, where it's almost a rarity when guys stick it out 2-3 years and develop inside the same program, when you can have the opportunity to do so at, you know, and probably play a bigger role somewhere else the very next season. So I think the departures were just kind of more the reality of our new portal world. And now the next step, once they solidify, you know, who all is going to leave and who all is going to come back, is going to be addressing your biggest needs in the portal. And what we do know is they need an elite level scorer to replace Casey, and they need a you know, rebounder, rim protector type guy to replace Josiah Alec in the front court. And then, you know, obviously, plays Kate had gone too. There's probably a little bit bigger need to add some more larger bodies in that front court. So I think those are probably the priorities right now when it comes to the portal. You just based off the guys that they brought in, you kind of see them starting to address that, and the interest that has been put out with players that have hit the portal. It kind of makes sense with the types of players they're going after. But yeah, I mean, Frankie Fiddler's on campus today. That's the first visitor. And so, like, with portal stuff, if a guy comes on a visit, then you know there's real mutual interest. Beyond him right now, it's all just kind of preliminary. And so I would imagine over the next week or so, you'll start to see some more movement on visits and see kind of who the realistic targets are. But one thing to keep in mind, you go back to last year, the majority of the transfer additions they brought in didn't happen until April and even May. So there's still some time for that to kind of shake itself out. And I still think the priority is making sure that you retain the key players from last year's squad that you want to make sure don't go anywhere.
Robin Washit joining us, HuskerOnline.com, part of the On3 Network. Wanted to follow up with you about Fiddler, Robin, because, you know, I've spoke to some people that think, like, no chance Nebraska lands him. And then, like, I had somebody reach out to me last night wondering, like, hey, where is that information coming from? Because I have heard the opposite. What's your read on the situation and how likely it is that Nebraska is able to get him?
Well, I mean, based off what I've heard, there is mutual interest there. And I think the biggest issue was, would it make sense for both sides? And to be honest with you, the big domino in that was C.J. Wilcher, because if Frankie Fiddler were to come to Nebraska, that would probably be the role that he would fill. Kind of a lot of the things that C.J. brought to the table, Frankie would kind of do the same thing. And so for Frankie to want to come to Nebraska, he needs that opportunity to play that role and get extensive minutes doing so. With C.J. in the picture, you kind of wonder just how likely that would be. Well, now that he's moved on, that door is wide open now, where a player of Frankie's skill set is now a need for Nebraska's portal kind of priority list here. So that I think that kind of changed the dynamic a little bit. Certainly, Frankie's got a multitude of options. He just visited Creighton. He's going to go see Wisconsin this weekend. You know, both of those schools have gotten a lot of momentum, just as much as Nebraska has. But, you know, with transfers, they're not, like, especially a kid from the state, like, he's not coming to Lincoln just to, like, tour the facilities and, like, see the practice center or the Pinnacle Bank. Like, that's, like, you don't waste your time doing that if you don't have a pretty high level of mutual interest. So I think the fact that he took that visit shows you that Nebraska is very much in the conversation. Now, does that change when he goes to Madison, or you know, looking back on his time at Creighton? I don't know, but I think you can't deny the fact that he made the effort to come down to Lincoln and spend the day here. You know, he went to football practice, he met with the coaching staff, they toured around everything, and you know, got the full pitch. So you don't do that unless you have you know, an actual real reason to take the time to do it. So I think Nebraska is very much in the conversation. And now that there's a role that is readily available for him to take on, I think that probably helps their causes even more so than it did a couple days ago.
Robin Wash at HuskerOnline.com. He joins us each and every Thursday at this time. Robin, we appreciate it as always. Enjoy the basketball tonight.
I will. You too, guys. And make sure that Connor stays out of trouble down there. I'm worried about him. He's off to a run.
He got in trouble
another,
a few minutes
another
ago.
Another whistle will be blown at me at some point.
Robin, he jumped into the pool, and they were blowing whistles at him.
You can't take him anywhere. It's a problem that we need to address going forward.
Don't put a Royals game on the TV. That's their fault.
They
should have known. Indeed. That's right. They should
have. Exactly.
You'd be in the pool if the Giants miraculously scored a touchdown.
Wow.
Yeah, well, I that happens so rarely. I don't even know what to do when they actually do it. So, I'd probably get thrown out. I'd be the one guy that gets thrown out of Vegas if the Giants scored a touchdown.
Exactly.
Thank you, Robin.
Bye, Robin.
See you guys.
Rob Washit joining us here on 1620 The Zone. I had another question for him, but it's hard sometimes to hear the answers. So I'll ask you the question when we return. So
I'll be like Robin.
So I have two questions for you when we
the Giants.
He does have kind of a drawl to it.
I don't know.
I'm Robin Wolf.
Oh, I don't know.
I'm getting on my horse. So when we return, I have two topics for you. Sorry to the what do they call? What is the Scrolls call Creighton fans?
Suck Jays.
Sorry to the Suck Jay fans. But we'll have plenty more on you tomorrow, including some audio from Marcus Blossom. We're going to save that for tomorrow. But when we return, I have two Nebraska-related topics for you. One is about hoops, putting a bow on things. And the other is something that popped into my mind in relation to stadium/name image likeness. Mm. So we'll have that for you as well. And so we can pick your brain on that. Also, we have some unsportsmanlike content to come with Nick.
We do.
Who, again, is writing his own questions. This is like when they allowed
young boy
Ringo Starr to start writing songs for the Beatles.
That worked out well.
I'm not even the best drummer in the Beatles. Bingo. Yeah, Yellow Submarine. It's a classic, though. We all remember that song. What classics will Nick drop on us today?
Wish we knew what it was about.
I can't figure out what that song is about or any of their songs are about. So we'll do that as well in the final hour of the show. And, yes, the 4 o'clock hour is indeed the final hour of the show today. It's very sad. We're off early today, Happer. It's actually going to be 3 when we say see you later here.
Yeah, but people don't care about that. They don't want to hear
really
vacation
don't.
Talk. They want to hear sports.
I'm trying to figure out what I'm having for food. That's the
what's
situation.
For dinner. We have a segment for that.
And we have what's for dinner to come. And it seems like we might have some options, some really good options.
I like the Asian place.
I think that's what we're going to do.
Asian place sounds good.
I think, I get to watch Nick eat rice in the wild. Expensive rice in the wild. All right, so we'll talk about that more and continue to roll on. Josh, Happer, Nick, Joey back in our studios. It is Unsportsmanlike Conduct live from Circa Resort and Casino and Stadium Swim in Las Vegas here on 1620 The Zone.
Nick Grimm for Circa Sports Iowa. You know, last night, Happer and I had a little peek-see at the sportsbook here at the Circa Resort and Casino in Las Vegas. And let me tell you, it's freaking great. Everything you need is right there. They make it easy. The graphics are clean, clear, easy to read. And the customer support is fantastic. Honestly, it reminded me a lot of the Circa Sports Iowa app that you can experience anywhere in the state of Iowa. That's the app you want to use when you can't make it out here to beautiful Las Vegas. They have tight money line splits. They don't keep as much money on large market bets. And when you're on a roll and winning a bunch, they won't even limit your account, which is great on a day like this on MLB opening day. There's a lot of things happening and a lot of things going on and a lot of opportunities for you to win. And again, just like on site, their customer support for the app is also elite. Shoot them an email, shoot them a tweet, and a real-life human being will help get you sorted out and help you with whatever you need. Check out the Circa Sports Iowa app today. If you or someone you know may have a problem with gambling, call 1-800-238-7633.
Live from the Host Coffee Studio, this is 1620 The Zone. 1620 The Zone. Traffic.
From the Pyramid Roofing Time-Saving Traffic Center, looks like there's some police activity that has westbound I-80 closed. Between L Street and Giles, you'll need to find an alternate route. Expect significant delays on westbound I-80. Also, a stall stuck on the entrance ramp from 144th to eastbound 370. And if you're south on 680, delays go from Pacific to I-80. If you're east on L Street, you're going to see delays going from I-80 all the way to 90th, and then stop and go traffic on westbound Dodge from 680 all the way to 120th. I'm Mike Neville.
This time-saving traffic is brought to you by Pyramid Roofing.
If you've seen the white trucks with Rufus, the spotted dog, then you know about Pyramid Roofing. Spring's almost here. Replace your siding, windows, roof, or gutters. Call Pyramid Roofing at 402-502-9300 or visit
pyramidroof.com.
never settle for less.
Hey, Omaha dog lovers, get ready for more wags and more fun. Hound HQ, your dog's favorite spot for daycare, boarding, and top-notch grooming, is now open. At Hound HQ, there's plenty of space for a pup to sleep, play, and everything in between. Plus, our expert groomers are here to ensure your furry family member always looks fabulous. Join our pack on Facebook and Instagram at The Hound HQ, or visit our website, thehoundhq.com, and sign up your dog today. Hound HQ, more wags, more fun.
Need tires but can't get away? Or is your company fleet plagued by unscheduled downtime? Check out Jensen Mobile Express Services at JensenTireAndAuto.com, the easiest way to get new tires delivered and installed at your location. Jensen.
At Cox Mobile, we know you're smart. You brush your teeth in the shower to save time, make coffee ice cubes for your cold brew, and wear goggles to cut onions. You also added Cox Mobile. So smart. Now you're running on the network with unbeatable 5G reliability and saving on your Cox internet. It's ingenious, just like you.
Aw, thanks.
Cox Mobile, the smart way to mobile. Cox postpaid internet required. Cox Mobile runs on the network with unbeatable 5G reliability as measured by Ookla LLC in the U.S. 2H2023. Other restrictions apply. Learn more at cox.com/mobile.
Betting on your favorite sporting events just got a whole lot easier. Warhorse Sportsbook is now open in Omaha. Save yourself the drive across the river and put your money where your mouth is at Horseman's Park, 6303 Q Street. Use the Warhorse app to check odds and build your bets before placing your wagers in person, including live in-game betting. No bets, no glory. Wagers may only be placed on Nebraska-based teams when played outside the state of Nebraska. Must be 21 or older to gamble. Gambling problem? Call 1-833-BETOVER.
It's Champions replacement window season, and we're celebrating with buy two windows, get two free. If your windows are drafty, difficult to operate, or costing you money on your energy bill, it's time to replace them. Champion Windows is here to help. Champion builds our own windows right here in the USA. We make the process easy. We help you choose the best design options for your home. We then build your project in our very own factory. Our install team manages your project every step of the way, and it's all backed by our lifetime guarantee. Turn your house into your dream home with more livable space in a new Champion sunroom, or enhance your curb appeal with new siding, now 30% off. Don't wait, this sale won't last long. Buy two windows, get two free, and 30% off sunrooms and siding. Call 877-GO-CHAMPION or visit championsavenow.com to schedule a free in-home estimate today. All discounts apply to our regular prices. Select styles apply. Minimum purchase required. Cannot be combined with other advertised offers. See store or website for details.
Tickets for less. Best seats, best prices, no service fees. Shop ticketsforless.com. KOZN Bellevue, Omaha, Council Bluffs. This is 1620 The Zone.
Josh Peterson, Connor Happer, Nick Grimm with you live at Stadium Swim at lovely Circa Resort and Casino in Las Vegas. It is day two for us here. We'll be back again tomorrow for the Connor Happer Show and for an abbreviated edition of Unsportsmanlike Conduct. It'll be a big day tomorrow, Happer.
Yeah.
With Creighton again playing in the Sweet 16. Coming up tomorrow night.
Third time in 4 years.
It's 7 o'clock. Oh, it's so early. It's so nice. Not to worry about anything.
For some people, it starts at 10 p.m.
Yeah, did you see that Mad Dog, he was John Bishop on ESPN the other day. I don't like that the games are this late.
Good take.
I thought you were going to say he's mad about
Colts. I really appreciate Mad Dog.
I do too. I think he's funny.
I think he's hilarious.
I don't watch his show, but I think he's funny whenever I see him pop up on the JTech Construction Zone Twitter feed.
He always does a good take on there.
Yeah.
Cole Reagan's just...
Yeah, what's going on?
He's getting out of some trouble right now.
The Cy Young winner, right?
It has been a little messier for him than I've wanted it to be.
Messy? He plays soccer. Nice, Nick.
Tariq Skubal, by the way, other Cy Young watch, is dealing in the bottom of the third against the horrible White Sox. And local product Jake Myers has hit a home run.
Well, the uniforms for the Houston are still Astros. Bad.
Yes.
Tiny
baby
them.
Letters. No.
They didn't fix them?
No, they did not.
This is horrible. By the way, a reminder that you can sign up for 1620 The Email, where you'll be first to know all the exciting content that's happening on 1620 The Zone, whether it's news, contests, promotions, or vlogs. You can sign up today at 1620thezone.com.
You want to see my nipples?
If you want to see,
go Happer, to the email list.
Yeah, did you take a close up of the nipples, Nick?
I didn't zoom in on the nipples.
Oh, well,
it all happened so fast.
That's a big disappointment there.
Nipples in your inbox.
Yeah,
I saw the nipples, and then I was just flooded.
Dude, when the internet first was existing nipples in the inbox. That's why you signed up for the internet. I don't know if it's so much Happers, but no, either way.
That's why we got the AOL subscriptions.
Mm-hmm. So, again, we'll be back here tomorrow ahead of Creighton playing in another Sweet 16 game. Happer, before I get to these Nebraska topics for you, I tell young Happer, who's watching that team on the hill, as they're called, that they're going to make three Sweet 16s in 4 years.
I still can't believe it.
What's the reaction from young Happer?
You don't even if it's normal me Happer right now, it's still surprising to me. I think about it way too often, probably. I need to adjust my brain to the fact that it's like they're good. Like they're really, really good. It's not that they're good. Like they've always had success. But tournament success and, you know, two seeds and one seeds and Big East championships and playing big games and beating the number one team in the country, like all that has happened. It's hard to fathom. If you told young me, it wouldn't really make any sense. I was excited when Creighton would play their bracket buster game against
Long Beach State
or St. Mary's or whoever they were matched up against in that random game. Or I would get fired up when they would be in the top 25 and they would get their score put on the bottom line on ESPN. I was so fired up about that. I was fired up when Nate Funk would score 17 points and I thought, this is as good as it's ever going to be. 17 points in singular basketball game. Creighton scored 68 one night and I was like, whoa, this is awesome. And then Doug McDermott came around and he changed my life. Doug, poll question. Did Doug McDermott change your life?
He certainly changed yours.
He did. He really did. And it's only gotten better since then. Every year since then, I've said, wow, this is probably as good as it gets, right? Mm-hmm. Like, it's never going to be, you know. At some point, it will end, but I don't know. I'm kind of planning on them being this good for a little while.
You said a few minutes ago, I don't know how it happened. How has this happened, though? Is it... Like, how much of this conversation is purely the coach? Like, the conversation beginning and ending. And I know there's a lot of different stories to be told on the journey that has gotten them here. But to be able to take this next step where they are a consistent team. Because it's funny, you said something else in that answer about, like, maybe I need to readjust my expectations. Because I follow a handful of Creighton fans who, I would say, have adjusted their expectations to a level where it's like, this is horrible when they're not making these types of runs or when they have a bad regular season game. And yet you are very much in the, I'm going to appreciate the hell out of all of this mode.
I try to be. I mean, that doesn't mean you can't be mad at a loss or whatever, but I was talking to that Kentucky guy over there and, you know.
Big Kentucky guy.
They're like, you know, they were thinking about firing their coach who had a $33 million buyout because he's gone – 2 out of 3 years where he's lost to a 15 and a 14.
Yeah.
Like that's a hard thing to swallow. But like traditionally it's going to be pretty good every single year and they have the best players and all that stuff. Like Creighton's in such a sweet spot where the expectations haven't risen beyond, maybe for some they have, the expectations haven't risen beyond the power and the grasp of the program yet. And they seem to exceed them every year.
Yeah.
Or get to them every year. What, like, when's the last time they didn't exceed expectations?
Dude, it's been a long time. It really has.
I mean, what? Seriously, like, is it they were in the NIT in, what, 16, I guess?
Yeah, the Cole Huff team?
Yeah, I guess, like, they might not have been. I don't know. Cole Huff even made the NCAA tournament.
But
once.
I think that team was, like, supposed to. It was, like, a part of that build back better.
It
was about the team that was trying to build back to being an NCAA tournament team because they bottomed out so bad the year prior, which was expected, though. It was a Missouri Valley roster, and they didn't have the best player in the country on the team.
Gosh, maybe that team did go to the tournament. Maybe that was the Rhode Island team.
No, the one that didn't exceed expectations or beat expectations.
I mean,
that's the one that, of course, had injuries to deal with, right? You know, like, it's pretty wild. Jeff writes on the text machine.
Oh, look. Hey,
this
Jeff.
Segment, puke emoji.
Oh.
Jeff's not a fan of this.
Well, they're really good.
They are really good.
I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm. Along those lines, though, I did want to ask you about Nebraska basketball.
We're done with Creighton?
We're done with Creighton for now. I have a topic, though, that's going to spin off from this that we can get to on tomorrow's show.
Maybe the people could stop puking now. We'll talk about Nebraska ball.
I wonder if you think that the season that was just completed for Nebraska will be remembered as its own thing, or is it remembered by being shaped by whatever happens next? Essentially,
yeah.
Like, I wonder if
I get you.
If the next of it all is actually going to tell the story more of the season that was just completed. But is so? Then I will ask two questions. So I don't mean to keep asking questions. But is
you're
that
very inquisitive boy?
Question for you.
Is that a cop out just because they lost? Because if they win last Friday, I'm not asking this question, how will this be remembered? Because I know what the answer is. But I'm almost kicking the can down the road a little bit because they were unable to get their first tournament win.
Right. No, I do. I am
inquisitive.
I do think this is the, well, at least you hope this is the start of something.
Yes.
And I think, I don't know, in the mini time frame, you still look at last year and you're like, oh, that was the start of this.
Yep.
And that's probably true as well. But yeah, I mean, the storyline changes significantly if they would have won that game. And it would have certainly changed the image of the season and what everything that we thought about it. Doesn't mean it was bad. Like, just because they, like, not all losses in the NCAA tournament are treated equal. Like, I know they haven't gone. They've been to the NCAA tournament what, 8 times?
This, like, is not when they were a 3 seed.
No,
and lost to Xavier, right?
Yeah, no. Like, that was a pretty good team. I think the general, the byline of the season for Nebraska, if you're writing the book, is 2023-2024 Nebraska basketball. They overachieved.
Yeah,
they overachieved.
It's just that by the time that they got to the end. The end game, the beginning of the end game.
Yeah, they couldn't cash in on, you know, maybe they're thinking a better matchup in that first game, or they play a little better on any given night. But that's like what it always is going to come. Like, they were a borderline top 25 team. Those teams traditionally get seeded right around where Nebraska did. Like, they didn't get jobbed on seeding or anything. Like, I think it played out for what they were, just as good, if not better, than you could have hoped for.
Yeah,
because there's a conceivable world where that team doesn't make the NCAA tournament.
Definitely.
Like, if they lose to Purdue and Wisconsin.
I was going to say.
They don't make the NCAA tournament, probably.
One of those two home wins go right. against them,
right.
and suddenly it changes everything.
Yeah, so there's a conceivable world where that team, the way it was constructed, doesn't even make it.
Yeah.
So, I mean, maybe that's a better way to think about it. So I think the overall outcome, like, is positive, even though it's a tough pill to swallow the way they lost.
Bernie writes, words uttered by Connor Happer never said before. You can stop puking. We're going to talk about Nebraska basketball for the last 20 years. Turning on a Nebraska ball game has cost more puking than cheap tequila.
Look, I'm not going to pretend to know what you people like or want. I'm just going to say what I want to say.
Ooh.
All right. I don't know what you guys are into.
Spicy.
I don't know what you guys are into.
Yeah. Hey, we're not going to kink shame on this show.
It's very odd to me, but it's okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you're right. I think that ultimately it's going to be judged by whatever happens next.
It's a net positive for this season. And yes, it, like, if they go on to win an NCAA tournament game in the next season, or
this was the
season after that, yeah, then you'll look at some members of this team, you'll look at Keisei Tomonaga, and you'll say, wow, this really set us up for this. Like, thank you, I appreciate it. Just like you looked at Bandebell and Griesel from last year, and you thought, and Walker, and you thought, wow, nice. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it. Their careers have aged well.
Yeah. We just got a text. Thanks for moving on from the Creighton talk. You guys are awesome when you're not talking about Creighton.
Wow.
Whoa.
I wish people would engage with this more on Creighton. I would love to talk about Creighton more.
More?
Yeah.
Like a September Creighton topic?
Yeah. Yeah.
That would be amazing.
I'd like to, like, but I just, I like to have conversations about the things that we enjoy. And I don't think the lack of what, this is a side topic probably.
Okay.
But, like,
go with it.
I don't think the lack of what we get, interaction that we get based on Creighton things, is all that representative of the people who care about it. I think there's more people who do care about it. I just think people are used to interacting about Husker football on this show and Husker basketball.
The Creighton interaction, I've always noticed, is way different.
It is.
It's a much different type of interaction or level of engagement. Joel says, we want to talk about spring football and fourth string running backs. Duh.
That's a bad take.
What about the guy who
think about something that matters?
Nebraska's going to run the option. What about that? Do you want to talk about Nebraska running the option?
Sure. I'd like to tell him that it's not going to happen.
Text to the 402. We don't want to engage with you on Creighton. We don't want to hear about them.
No, once again, you don't speak for everybody.
No one engages Creighton Tuck because no one cares about
That's not true. That's objectively not true. They have 18,000 people who go to their game every single game. That's objectively not true. You walk around town or you go to Shields in Village Point, and what is there? There's a section for Creighton stuff, and people buy it. I know it's amazing to some people, but you live in your own bubble, and it's time to get out of it.
Pedro says, hi, guys. Can you finally start talking about the Berkshire meeting that will happen later this year?
They'll be lined up outside of the prophet of Omaha's house.
I love
that
you,
one
Pedro.
Guy said.
Andy says, what do you mean, you people? And Keenan says, I dislike Creighton, but I find people hating on Creighton Talk more annoying than Creighton itself.
Good take by Keenan.
Keenan. Pronounced with a hard C. It's cleaner that way.
Yeah.
Bernie says, you can talk about Creighton all you want. I enjoy good basketball.
That's all I'm talking about, right? That's a very normal take.
Here we go. Text from the 402. More Creighton talk, less Nebraska basketball.
Like I said, there's people out there who care about this stuff. I know there. I know there is.
15,000 of those people are there for wine and cheese.
I don't think it's fair for the Husker fan dude who loves the message boards and four string running back talk to come in and be like, nobody cares about this crap. It's just not true. People say that all the time. They're like, you want to know why they don't talk about Creighton? You want to know why they would never talk about Creighton? Because nobody cares about Creighton. That's not true. People do care about Creighton.
We're J's for pay.
I don't even know what point I'm trying to make anymore. I'm mad about it,
though. It's hour seven of radio.
Yeah, I'm mad about it.
It's like John never left. Happer has a soapbox.
Yeah, do you have any soapboxes that you want to get on beyond the Creighton one?
So many. Yeah.
Basketball's better than football.
I mean, it's not naturally coming up yet, but...
Uh-oh.
Or we could talk about instant replay anytime you want.
Oh, that'd be an odd topic.
I hate instant replay.
Just in general?
Yeah,
in
I think
sports?
They should cancel all of it.
I don't like that instant replay in at the end of a basketball game has turned into, let's zoom in on the fingers.
Oh, did he take bend backwards?
If a defender knocked the ball out of bounds, it was out off of the defender,
yeah.
And now it's not if it's in the last 2 minutes of
the
game.
It's the same thing with the neighborhood play at second base. It's stupid. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
A text of the 402. The 18,000 that go to their games aren't listening to 1620. They're listening to whoever took over for Rush Limbaugh. Creighton fans, handshake
Creighton
meme,
fans?
Rush Limbaugh's corpse.
Is that the crowd?
I don't know. There's probably a little bit of that crowd, right?
There's obviously a little bit of it.
Yeah, I guess there's a little bit of that everywhere.
Yeah.
I did have another Nebraska-related topic for you, Happer.
Okay.
This is less
GBR.
This is less football or less basketball and a bit more football. But it's kind of in the aggregate, and it's funny because you just mentioned the message boards. I will admit that I saw this poll question on the scrolls, and I was like, that's actually a great topic.
Oh, a scroll question.
And so
Theo's going to love this.
I'm going to reframe it, though.
Would.
I'm going to reframe it because it was essentially, where would you rather give your dollars, to a stadium or to NIL? I think that that's actually the wrong question to ask. So I'm going to ask it to you this way.
Bad question.
Does it have to be one or the other? Why can it not be both? Why has this turned into you can only give $450 million to the stadium or you can only give $450 million to NIL? Because, look, in that phrasing, it was hilarious to me because you're not going to do $450 million to name, image, likeness tomorrow. Like, that's impossible.
Mm-hmm.
What would a roster look like if Nebraska's paying $450 million?
It'd be pretty good.
They'd probably win a national championship.
They could.
You know, real quick aside, the rest of the sport would be so mad. If Nebraska paid a roster $450 million just to win one natty and then say peace out.
That's why they got to get the
– All right, never mind.
That's why they got to get the Saudi money.
They should do it. That would be pretty funny.
1 year of Saudi?
As a bit. Nick, what do you think about
Live
that?
Nebraska?
I shouldn't have – I like Formula One. I don't know
if
I can have an opinion.
You're really
this.
Not allowed to make fun of this.
Would you do 1 year of Live Nebraska?
Oh, man. I mean, I would definitely get on my high horse about it. I would think that that'd be bad. But why can't fans just donate $450 million?
You would win, but it wouldn't be fun.
It would not be fun.
It would be fun to watch them win, but
it would be an amazing story.
There would be no heart. It would have no soul. It would be soulless.
Absolutely.
Would you rather soulless win or just continue to lose?
You're a ginger. You tell us.
I don't know. I think maybe it's probably just continue to lose. I like having a soul.
Yeah.
Why would you not want to lose with soul than win without?
Nice. Cody texts, get Happer a Snickers as he is getting hangry.
I am.
We all are all very
I hungry. Need rice.
We need rice and brisket.
Someone in the YouTube did tell me to give you some of my rice.
No, I don't need your rice. I just need my own.
To go back to the question.
I need more Royals hits, too. This is...
Why is it just one? Why can't it be both? Why are they not able to fix the stadium and to pay players? Is that possible? Am I an idiot?
I also don't think you need to spend $450 million on the stadium. You could also do a smaller version of, like, you don't have to do the Grand Trev Vision. Yeah. You don't have to do Trev South Stadium.
I wonder what instead of $450 million, what like $200 million gets you, you know? I mean, like, what does that get you right now?
To be honest, I do think that is the best idea.
Yeah,
it also requires the most investment.
Yeah. Because don't you think that
eventually they're going to have to wreck it?
Yes. Doing a $450 million renovation, it doesn't just fix it. It alters it completely.
Yeah.
And then it maybe expands the life of the stadium.
Yeah.
I mean, not maybe. It does expand the life of the stadium. Whereas if they continue to lipstick it up. And here's the thing, though, man. They haven't lipstick on a pig the other sides of the stadium. They have fixed. They have done big-time changes in west, in north, and in east.
Yeah.
So just to do a couple of fixes, I don't know if that's the great play long term.
Yeah. No, it's probably not, but it doesn't. I think the blessing of like Trev leaving, honestly, is you get to reset on all that stuff.
Yeah, you definitely do.
You get to figure out your priorities a little bit, but I do like the question. We'll get to that here in just a second, but it can be both. It probably should be both, and the best places will have both.
Yeah.
And Nebraska is at a place right now where that vision and the idea of like, we're going to be ready. We're going to be the last people to do these facilities upgrades and do all this stuff. It was at a place when Trev left where it just isn't, it's not done yet. And so like, I think there is a real, like, we want to finish this before we go full into the NIL era. And that's a real thing. Like, I understand that.
Yeah.
So I think you can and probably should do both. Like, you don't need this. What does a gigantic NIL war chest look like?
Well, Ohio State will talk about how they need like $13 million a year for their roster. And that's retention.
Right.
So and I then would say,
and another pool of money on the side for acquisition.
So I would say
20?
15 to 20 to be safe.
20 maximum.
Yeah, let's say that. Let's say $20 million.
Yeah, if you're doing $450 or $600, then what's 20?
Yeah, 20 can go into $450 million. You know,
yeah.
A lot of times.
Or do a
20 something times.
Or do a smaller version of the 450 thing, and you know, do a toned down version of Trev's big idea, as we'll call it. Hashtag Trev's big idea.
Trev's big idea.
And then you have plenty of money left for NIL. Like, it's going to be okay. There's enough out there. I say this while saying it's not any of my money.
Yeah, and I will not donate either. Pedro says, hi, how much will a new stadium cost? Lincoln should have a bake sale and crime spree to help with the money. That's true. When you
we'll
get
do
in trouble,
crimes for...
When you get in trouble with crime, you have to pay.
Yeah, Venmo.
But maybe some of that points on the package could go to the stadium project. I think...
I've formed my own platform about a new stadium recently.
All right.
If they build one, they should put it in Gretna.
So Nick says, build a new stadium.
Nick wants Big Lake, big stadium.
In Gretna.
Yeah.
Big names and big games.
Interesting.
We got it all.
I like this question from Andrew. I'm listening, but I'm watching Joey look left and right nonstop. Can you explain his job? I watched Joey a little bit earlier too, and it was really funny. I just like how Joey takes up half of the screen.
Yeah, he is.
It's Joey doing nothing.
He's not doing nothing.
He's doing a great job.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
But he is doing some things.
Nick, what do you think of the job that Joey is doing as a producer? Of producing?
I think he's decent at producing.
Wow.
Oh. I think when he replies to people on the StreamYard, he should focus where that reply is going instead of going to all three places we're streaming.
Okay, calm down.
Actually, that's explaining my job, Nick.
That's a fine criticism from Nick, because if John did that, I would make fun of him too.
Which he does.
He does.
It's a bit of a nitpick.
John replies all.
We're on the air, right?
If Josh is going to backseat produce me, I'm going to backseat produce Joey.
I love this. We got to backseat produce everybody. Check the backseat.
Produce all you guys.
Gina says, Joey is me in all my work Zoom meetings. Cody says,
he kind of does look like that.
Cody says, this is the lamest poolside radio show 7 hours inside a guy's living room. Move outside and show the nips. It is sunny now, it looks like the
nips are for the vlog.
No, never mind. The wind is still windy.
Nips are an online exclusive.
No, that's a great point, Josh. Please understand why we're not outside right now.
Yes.
It's because it is extremely windy. All of our stuff would blow away, and all you would hear would be wind.
All of our stuff would also blow up.
Yeah.
Blow it up.
So that's why we're not out there.
We have gotten a picture from our friend Jacob Bigelow of Trev Albert's I did that.
Trev's grand plan
for the stadium.
They should have called it the Trev's Big Idea Stadium.
We'll send that out.
Well, then
they'd
have to change the name again because people don't like him anymore.
We'll send that out for our dear friends of the Grum.
Trev, by the way, Trev will age fine.
Yes.
Oh.
Trev will age fine.
You think
people
so?
Will get over this.
Dude, Steve Sipple has not gotten over that.
He has not.
He
but
is
he
so
will.
Mad.
He will. Trev will be just fine in the eyes of Husker fans. He should stop tweeting probably for a little while, but he'll be just fine. Husker fans will be all right.
By the way, if you missed it before we go to break, there was a politician in Michigan who was trying to earn some points posting a video of Gonzaga landing and referring to them as illegal invaders for the regional there. Well, shout out to Travis, listener Travis, who just tweeted at us. He says, I hope Gonzaga, Creighton, and the rest of the teams in Detroit don't get deported. Wild seeing a Rob Anderson quote in the story. And so sure enough, I have now opened it up.
Oh, no.
Rob Anderson, sports information director at Creighton University, told CNN that their team landed at the airport Wednesday afternoon, had buses waiting, and received a police escort as well. I was on one of those buses.
Oh, my God.
So
Rob got texted by CNN?
Rob got hit up by Jake Tapper just tweeted out the story, by the way. I know Daniel Dale. Oh, Daniel Dale, that's the Trump fact checker, right? Who used to be like, Trump just said this. He's lying.
Oh, my God.
Wow. So shout out Rob Anderson.
Do you remember a time in society where something like this wouldn't have been tweeted in the first place and then the responding events would never have happened because the first thing wouldn't have happened?
Yes,
anyway.
Those were better times.
It was a different time, Nick. It was a different time. That doesn't happen anymore.
The Orioles are the first team. Oh, I thought they were shaking hands.
No, it's the middle of the seventh.
Yeah.
One more text from the 402. Why don't they sell naming rights to the stadium?
They certainly could.
People would be so mad. They would be so mad.
What if somebody paid?
It's
what
a
if
nice you cash infusion?
What
though.
If you? What if you sold naming rights to just the South Stadium?
Oh, that would be great. South
Trev Albert South.
Welcome
Stadium.
To Tom Osborne Field at Memorial Stadium, featuring.
Well, no, the announcers would say it. He's going towards South Stadium, brought to you by Burger King.
Aurora Co-op South Stadium.
I don't hate that idea. I don't hate that idea. All right, we still have more to come. We are winding down the program for today. Again, we will be off at the top of the hour to get you ready for some hoops. We have not a quadruple header because we just have four games tonight. But we have four games tonight coming up, including the defending national champions. UConn will play at 6:39. The first game of the evening is Arizona versus Clemson at 6:09. And then after that, Bama and UNC, as well as Iowa State and Illinois.
That's a banger.
That the last one?
Yes.
Yeah, where will we be watching that game? That is the question.
Rice Restaurant.
We'll be doing it. I don't want to wait until 7:39 to eat.
Yeah, I need food.
That's 5 hours from now.
We'll find something to do.
Yeah, we will. But where will we be watching that? Perhaps we'll be here at the Stadium Swim at Circa Resort and Casino. We're having an awesome time. We appreciate Circa for bringing us out. The cabana is great.
The cabana boys.
It's windy outside, but it is not windy on the inside. More to come as we wrap up the show today. We'll have some content at the bottom of the hour. What's for dinner later on as well. It is on Sportsmanlike Conduct here on 1620 The Zone. Hey everyone, Josh Peterson here for the FanDuel Sportsbook. As we have talked about today, baseball season has begun, and right now new customers can start the Major League Baseball season off with $200 in bonus bets if your first $5 bet wins. That means $200 that you can spend on moneyline totals, strikeouts, home runs, whatever it is. All you got to do is go to FanDuel.com/1620 today. And one of the best parts, one of my favorite parts, is the live lines are all there on the main page. Just open it up and you have a bevy of games that are going on right now, but you have all of those live lines for you, like this one, Happers Royals taking on the Twins.
The Twins up 2-1. The Royals plus 150 on the money line if you like them to come back and get a win about halfway through that game. Again, just go to FanDuel.com/1620 and get $200 in bonus bets if that $5 bet wins. 21 plus in President, Iowa. First online real money wager only. $10 first deposit is required. Bonus issued is non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-BETS-OFF.
You get a lot of junk in your inbox. This one, not junk. Not junk at all. 1620 The Email. Exclusive content, contests, other stuff probably. Subscribe today at 1620thezone.com. Your Omaha area forecast from a Godfather's Pizza Weather Center and KETV News Watch 7 on 1620 The Zone.
Mostly sunny skies and a little bit of haze for your Thursday afternoon with a high today in Omaha of 62 and southerly winds up to about 10 miles an hour. Increasing clouds this evening and tonight. Still fairly mild though with a low by tomorrow morning of 42. Partly to mostly cloudy to end your work week. High on Friday, 68. I'm meteorologist Caitlin Harvey with KETV News Watch 7.
1620 The Zone's Unsportsmanlike Conduct, brought to you by a great friend of the program, Union Bank and Trust.
1620 The Zone Traffic.
From the Pyramid Roofing Time-Saving Traffic Center, looks like that police activity still has westbound I-80 closed. Between L Street and Giles, traffic is stopped all the way back to 680. Find an alternate route. You've also got delays on southbound 680, starting from Dodge going all the way to I-80. If you're east on I-80, delays from 680 to 84th. You still got that stall blocking the off-ramp from 144th to eastbound 370, and then stop-and-go traffic on westbound Dodge from 680 all the way to 120th. I'm Mike Neville.
This time-saving traffic is brought to you by Saul's Jewelry and Loan.
Sometimes life throws you a curveball and you need a solution fast. A solution to help you make payroll, to save your house, to keep growing, or fund a startup, to fix a roof or other major repair. Saul's is your fast, local, confidential solution. Get the cash you need today with Saul's.
Trees, are they all the same? Not at Lanahaw. Grown from a quality seed source, handcrafted in our local farms for generations, and acclimated to our tough Midwestern climate, Lanahaw's trees are different. Simply put, they're better. Much like our trees, we take great pride in being homegrown. Visit our garden center to find your next tree today. Rooted in quality, unmatched value, Lanahaw Nurseries, 192nd and Center.
If you're looking for a safe and reliable vehicle to get you through all types of winter weather and more, Baxter Subaru has you covered. Symmetrical all-wheel drive comes standard on nearly all Subaru models and provides you better traction, improved stability, and maximized performance on wet and snowy roads. So hop in the driver's seat of a new Outback, Forester, or Crosstrek now at Baxter Subaru Omaha. Shop our great sales and service deals now during the Subaru A Lot to Love event at BaxterSubaruOmaha.com.
The GOAT is coming to Kansas City. Sporting KC will host Inter Miami and Lionel Messi, the greatest of all time, at the loudest stadium in the world. See Johnny Russell, Alan Pulido, and the rest of your hometown team take on Messi, Luis Suarez, and more at GEHA Field at Arrowhead Stadium on Saturday, April 13th. It's the soccer capital of America versus the greatest of all time. Get your tickets while you still can at SportingKC.com.
Oscar's Pizza and Sports Grill is your home for the big game. We're in the middle of the best time of the year of basketball season, with meaningful games every night, with 40 TVs and massive dual projectors. The games have never looked better. Pair that with their award-winning char-buffed wings and $7.99 Monday through Friday lunch specials. Oscar's Pizza and Sports Grill has everything you need. 173rd and West Center Road, and for takeout, 162nd and Maple.
What moves you? Whether it's running a race or playing with your grandkids, orthopedic specialists at CHI Health are dedicated to helping you keep life moving. We offer the latest surgical and non-surgical treatments, so you have options for painful shoulders, knees, hips, and every joint in between. Don't let joint pain put life on pause. Count on our team of orthopedic specialists to begin your journey back to what moves you today.
Lindley Clothing in Omaha has been the premier provider of men's fashion for over 88 years, from suits to jeans, with great brands like Jack Victor, Bugatti, Peter Millar. Your father was a customer. You're a customer. Your son is a customer, and now they're looking for the latest sportswear to tailored clothing. Lindley Clothing has you covered. They will help you get the look that you need with their selection and top-notch customer service. You walk in the door, and there's John and Marlene and the entire Lindley Clothing team with a great smile on their face and there to help you. 132nd and West Dodge in Linden Market to pick up the latest styles and enjoy easy access.
The Zone Hotline is powered by 42 Degrees, The Source, by your mom's house.
Roofing, siding, and gutters. Make the right call with the Rooferies at John Higgins Weather Guard.
It's unsportsmanlike conduct.
Ali, Ali, oxen free!
The 1620, The Zone.
Josh Peterson, Connor Happer, and Nick Grimm with you live at Stadium Swim at Circa Resort and Casino in Las Vegas. 8 Fremont Street is the address. What a fun address.
Eight
Fremont
Street. I wish that was my address.
Dude, you know
eight.
What? You know what I will say that I have done in like an hour and a half?
Eight. I would like to eight.
I'm so excited.
Past tense, eight.
Yeah, I'm pumped.
Pumped for food?
I'm going to eat food, and we're going to split an appetizer of some sort, so we'll be doing that later. James writes in, did some UNL fan suggest that Creighton fans are Rush Limbaugh devotees?
Yeah, that was weird.
That is way more likely to occur in their rural, ag-based, pill- and Trump-loving Big Red cohorts than among a progressive group of CU fans.
Yeah.
Look at this, the politics boys.
Let's not do that, because there's all kinds of people who root for many things.
Yes.
Yes.
Lots of handshake memes.
Yes.
Lots of handshake memes. Money Chris said, what a great transition. Speaking of vomit, Nebraska ball. Wow. It didn't seem like the return on investment for that whole segment. It seems like we got thumbs down from everybody.
Yeah, we somehow managed to trigger everyone.
Yeah. Nobody was happy. I did like this text, though, from Joe. Dorothy Lynch South Stadium. So there you go, a sponsorship idea for the stadium.
It's any number of great sponsors can just say, presented by South Stadium. This presented by South Stadium runs a stadium.
All right, now more text coming in about progressiveness. All right, we're just going to move on. We're going to eject from this segment as quickly as possible. Happer, you said it earlier. Among the four games tonight, the one that you are most looking forward to is the last one.
Yes.
Illinois versus Iowa State, a trip to the Elite Eight on the line. That is a 2-3 matchup. And the other thing we talked about yesterday was just given the seeding of these teams, you got a lot of good ones. A 2-6, that's Arizona versus Clemson. A 1-5, that's Connecticut versus San Diego State. And then a 1-4, that is North Carolina and Alabama. And I think the team that we agree that is most likely to move on is going to be UConn.
Yeah.
Does it seem like the other games are up in the air, or do you feel anywhere near as confident with one of those other teams to get a victory and go to the Elite Eight?
I wish I knew more about Clemson, you know? I don't trust Arizona particularly, but I do find it surprising that Clemson is in the spot they're in right now. So, I mean, you could go with that one. Alabama is always going to be kind of like a boom or bust type of situation. They were exploding when they almost lost to Grand Canyon a couple days ago. Like,
dude, they
let's get 700 technicals and nonstop foul people. Great idea.
Yeah.
It's not a very disciplined team, but they can, you know, score with the best of them. That's for sure. And North Carolina has been relatively consistent lately. And then, you know, Iowa State, Illinois is just going to be a really good game, I think. Like, those are two really good teams. They both have strengths that combat each other's strengths, I think, really well. So what was the question? Most likely team to move on?
No, just who are you confident in? Or really the better one is, are you confident in anyone else tonight? Because we're super confident in UConn.
In other words, who you rooting for?
Who you confident in?
This is not who you rooting for. This is who you confident in.
And by the way, the lines for tonight, you have 12 points. That's the UConn game, obviously. Otherwise, you have a 1.5, you have a 4.5, and a 6.5.
Arizona, by the way, just went from 7.5 to 6.5, to 6.5.
Look at that, live movement on the odds board.
Team I'm most confident in, give me Arizona.
Arizona, dude. But it seems like that's because you don't feel like you know as much about Clemson.
Yeah, and look, I mean, Yeah, it's definitely about Clemson. I mean, Arizona, I don't trust them all the way for sure. So, yeah, I guess it's Arizona tonight. But that is all to say, outside of UConn, that is all to say, I think we're going to get, I think we're going to get four really good games, actually.
You think so? You think the UConn-San Diego State game goes
I would take San Diego State to cover that.
I would, too. Tomorrow's the better day, right? We're more excited about tomorrow.
Yeah, Gonzaga-Purdue is awesome. Obviously you got Creighton.
Duke Houston, I think, is fun.
Duke Houston is super fun. I don't really care much about NC State Marquette.
And that's because of NC State. They've ruined our Sweet 16.
They did. These damn 11 seeds.
Yeah.
These damn small program Cinderellas.
Yeah.
Sickening.
They're the only one of this group that I am just like not excited to watch again. But I mean, look, I got to give it up to them. How many games in a row did they win in the ACC tournament?
Five.
So they've won seven consecutive postseason games.
Each of them with their life on the line.
Yes. So, I mean, in a way, it's like shout out to you guys. I just kind of wish that I didn't have to watch you anymore.
DJ Burns?
You'll get another win tomorrow.
You like a little DJ Burns action? Or are you done with the fat guy narrative?
No. I don't say that about me.
America's saying you might like this guy because he's fat.
I have no takes on him.
Okay.
No takes at all.
Not even a little bit.
No, not even.
Apparently, he owns a line of vending machines.
Oh, that's fun.
Yes.
Wow, NIL, man. It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
It's a good investment.
He is a big boy.
He just makes money every day.
His numbers look like the numbers of baseball jerseys, very tiny, but it's not because the uniforms are bad. It's just because of his size.
He's nuts, man. He was stink eyeing some people in Pittsburgh.
Oh.
Yeah. He was looking. He was picking out individual people in the Oakland section, just looking at them.
Interesting.
The entire game.
What a guy.
Very weird.
All right, when we come back, it'll be time for some unsportsmanlike content with one Nick Grimm.
Yes.
You all right there, Nick?
Yes.
Okay, cool. So we'll have that. Also,
you don't seem okay.
I'm hungry. I was also breathing in at the time
really
Josh was talking. Like, it was a kind of a yawn.
That's why I was worried. I looked over and I just see you breathing, and I was like, oh, no, is he getting nervous about content?
Don't breathe anymore.
Yeah. By the way, score update for you. Baltimore 11, Los Angeles 1.
Bad take, Nick.
Nick, that take is aging terribly.
Nick, Mike Trout is indeed overrated or a bust.
But the home run.
Yes, but we're talking about
two home runs.
No, busts don't lose.
Oh, by the way,
speaking
of the guy who said that, he's on his way to Detroit, Michigan. He's in the car with Mr. Degrassi himself.
Oh,
yeah, Drake Degrassi. They're in the vehicle. They're making their way.
That's a bit of a haul.
It's about 9 hours or so.
Yeah, that's a
there you go.
That's a trip.
Yep, they're heading to.
What does Jimmy always look like that?
Why does Jimmy always look like that? Jimmy, do you think Jimmy is someone that in his life has been told you need to smile more? men love saying that to women. Do men also love saying that to Jimmy?
Problematic men like saying that.
I don't ever tell a woman that she should smile.
Never say that to anybody.
There was an article about that in the World Herald like 8 years ago.
I remember that.
And I was like, I hope that I haven't said this before. You should smile more, but we'll say it to Jimmy. Jimmy, you should smile.
Why is he
more.
Always triggered about it? He's always taking stuff so seriously.
Oh, yeah. I wonder how he's feeling about his Caleb Williams won't get picked number one overall by the Bears take. That one is.
Oh, I forgot about that one.
Yeah, another one of his
takes. That's
take.
A really bad take.
He's really good at being wrong all the time, which is kind of impressive in its own.
Except for picking games against the spread. He's somehow kind of good at that.
Asian Joe says, poll question, does Jimmy have resting Jimmy face?
New bit. No, we love these new bits. All right.
RJF.
All right. We'll get to some content when we return and also what's for dinner. And my God.
A lot.
You know how there's brunch? This is Linner. We're going to be eating.
Oh, I love Linner.
I'm very excited about that. That's still to come here on 1620 The Zone.
Nick Grimm for Circa Sports Iowa. We are currently in the thick of opening day with all of these games happening right now. You have so many chances to win anywhere in the state of Iowa with the Circa Sports Iowa app. If you want fun props, which are my personal favorite, they got you covered. If you want tight money line splits, they got you covered. They also don't keep as much money on large market bets, and when you're on a roll and winning a bunch, they won't limit your account either like some other places like to do. They want you to keep winning. And also, don't forget, when they say it's like having the hospitality of Vegas in the palm of your hand, they aren't lying. Just last night when I was partaking at the sportsbook, their customer service was just the best. Answered all my questions, everything was nice. Clear, concise, and that is what you could experience from the comfort of your home anywhere in the state of Iowa. Check out the Circa Sports Iowa app today. If you or someone you know may have a problem with gambling, call 1-800-238-7633.
Now live on Twitch, YouTube, and 1620thezone.com.
Car repair is car repair. Most places you go can change your oil or fix your brakes. The difference is the experience you'll get at Omaha Car Care. We're part of the community. We were born here, and we believe that our relationship with you should be built to last. We're going to consult you, not sell you. We're going to give you a free loaner car. We're going to treat you like a valued friend that we want to continue to see in the years to come. I'm Rick Betker, owner of Omaha Car Care, and we'll be along for the ride.
JTech Construction, the official exterior experts of the Huskers, offers exterior solutions that help you protect your number one investment. Whether it's roofing and siding or windows and doors, they're committed to excellence, quality, and outstanding customer service in every step of the process. When it's time to protect the exterior of your home, your choice is simple. Turn to who the Huskers turn to, JTech Construction. Check them out online and schedule a free estimate today. JTech Construction. The official exterior experts of the Huskers.
The world's largest sports book in Las Vegas is available right at your fingertips in Iowa. The Circa Sports Iowa app is sports betting the way it should be. Bet anywhere in Iowa and experience high betting limits, tight money line splits, and exceptional customer service. Download your new bookie today. Visit circasports.com and start betting like a pro from anywhere in Iowa. If you or someone you know may have a problem with gambling, call 1-800-238-7633.
Are you ready? Corn, live in concert in Omaha. CHI Health Center, Friday, October 25th. With special guests, Gojira and Spirit Box. Corn. Get tickets this Friday at 10 a.m. at Ticketmaster.com. For more, visit cornofficial.com.
Velocity Clinical Research in Omaha frequently conducts clinical trials for a broad range of investigational treatments. Typical studies involve medications for high cholesterol, diabetes, infectious diseases, acne, and others. Some current studies include low T, COPD, flu, pediatric, infant, and RSV. They also perform vaccine studies for people of all ages, conducting innovative research that has a positive impact online. See current trials at Velocity Clinical. ClinicalTrials.com. Compensation for study-related time and travel. Find out more at VelocityClinicalTrials.com.
At Cox Mobile, we know you're smart. You brush your teeth in the shower to save time, make coffee ice cubes for your cold brew, and wear goggles to cut onions. You also added Cox Mobile. So smart. Now you're running on the network with unbeatable 5G reliability and saving on your Cox Internet. It's ingenious, just like you.
Aw, thanks.
Cox Mobile, the smart way to mobile. Cox postpaid internet required. Cox Mobile runs on the network with unbeatable 5G reliability as measured by Ookla LLC in the U.S. 2H2023. Other restrictions apply. Learn more at cox.com/mobile.
1620 The Zone and 1620thezone.com. 1620 The Zone's unsportsmanlike conduct is brought to you by Union Bank and Trust. Now back to the program.
Look, I made you some unsportsmanlike content.
Unsportsmanlike content. Content.
Unsportsmanlike content.
Content.
Content that's unsportsmanlike.
All right, it's time for some unsportsmanlike content. If you missed this yesterday, we had Nick write his own questions for the segment. Nick, you got to do it again. Take it away.
Yesterday on Good Morning Football, Panthers wide receiver Adam Thielen said that, quote, everything was stacked against rookie quarterback Bryce Young. He also said he wasn't going to get into detail as to why. What do you two think?
Wait, so who said that about him?
Thielen.
Adam Thielen said what about who?
Just reread the question, Nick. Sorry.
Yesterday on Good Morning Football, Panthers wide receiver Adam Thielen said that everything was stacked against rookie quarterback Bryce Young. He also said he wasn't going to get into detail as to why. What do you two think?
Oh, I think they had a bad team.
Horrible team.
So I guess to act, you know, to go off of what Adam Thielen said, yes, it was stacked against him in that he had a bad team. Adam Thielen was part of the bad team, for the record. Yeah, I mean, so much of playing quarterback, especially as a rookie, is situational and like who's around you. And with that being said, he's probably still not as good as CJ Stroud, you know,
my boy.
But yes, it was definitely stacked against him.
Definitely was, yeah. I mean, they had to fire a coach how many games into the season? That happened. Horrible owner. Offensive line was garbage. No skill player. I mean,
and Matt Rhule.
Think about it.
He did that.
Oh, Matt Rhule hanging over everything. Think about
yes.
it. Adam Thielen was like the name skill player. And Adam Thielen is old.
Unless you really like LaVisca Chenault.
Unless I do like LaVisca Chenault, so that's
cool
fair.
Name.
Yeah. It is a great name, but he's not like that guy. So... yeah, he didn't have a lot going for him, but I will also say, when I watch him play quarterback, I get worried about him.
Yeah.
He's so tiny.
He's a little, he's also timid, yeah. You know.
I thought he was going to be good, but man, I feel like I'm already way off on him in the NFL.
You got to put him in the right situation.
Mm-hmm.
Good news for fans of Washington, D.C. sports.
Ugh.
The Wizards and the Capitals will be staying at Capital One Arena through 2050 through a new agreement that includes $500 million in cash from the city for renovations and new noise restrictions.
Okay.
Cool.
Wow. This is
cool that the team is not moving. The teams that we don't care about aren't moving.
So Unsportsmanlike content is billed as the segment where we save topics that we perhaps missed out on earlier. This is definitely one
this
of them.
This would have not been a topic.
We missed out on talking about this earlier.
There's not a lot going on right now.
Sure.
That's fair.
Congrats to the Washington, the DMV sports fans as they were.
Huge.
Congrats to them on having their team. I've been to that arena before. I saw the Capitals play. I had tickets near the ice. I was able to touch the glass.
Did you bang on it?
Behind the glass. I did. It was awesome.
Instead of touch grass, it's... Touch glass.
I got to watch Alex Ovechkin score a goal. It was awesome.
Mm.
Half of your takes.
Let's see. I have never been to that arena. I've driven by it.
Oh, there you go.
Yep. And it is in Washington, D.C.
Wow, he's right on this one, folks.
Georgetown plays there, and nobody goes.
Nobody goes.
Any news on Georgetown? Do they get to stay?
Oh, great question, Happer.
I didn't see that in the article I read.
Is Georgetown leaving?
Maybe Georgetown's getting kicked out.
Oh.
Speaking of Georgetown, did you see the funny internet? Did you see the funny internet tweet about Ed Cooley?
Oh no!
Somebody made
how
it.
How old does that make Happer sound? Did you see the internet tweet?
Somebody did a tweet that Ed Cooley
on
was resigning.
Oh, that's fun.
Yeah, I mean, he's not.
Yeah,
just
he's
to be very, very clear,
coach, yeah.
He's definitely not resigning. But yeah, it was pretty funny. He's like, I can't handle this. They had like a fake quote from him. He's like, I can't handle this anymore. The rebuild is going to be very hard and I'm out.
Mm.
But it wasn't true.
Fellas, as I'm sure you know, it's opening day.
Oh, yes,
baseball, dingers, hot dogs, dongs, as some call.
Those are dingers.
Josh, Nick, can you give Happer and I one baseball hot take for this season that we can include on the list?
Oh, a hot take?
Get the eggs.
Oh, man. I mean, it's not a hot take to say the Angels are going to suck.
Nope.
I don't know if I have any hot takes. You know what? I think that is it a hot take to say that the regular season success will translate to postseason success?
Oh.
It's going to be a very chalky postseason.
So, okay, how about you get more specific then? How about you say we're crafting a take right
okay.
now? How about you say that the team with the best record
will win the
wins the World Series?
Sure. At
will
the very
you say
least,
that?
The team with the best record will make the World Series.
Okay.
And the team with the top four teams, that will be the teams that are in the
now,
World Series.
To make a perfect take, why don't you just pick who that team is going to be?
Dodgers will win the World
the
Series.
The Dodgers will be the best team in the regular season and win the World Series.
And win the World Series. It's going to be like the olden
there
days.
There you go. Mark them down. Get
put
the
it
eggs.
On the list.
Yep.
Damn it, not to put the list
yeah.
together. All right.
Get the eggs.
Per Zach Rosenblatt on The Athletic about an hour ago,
Rosenblatt.
The New York Jets owner, Woody Johnson, said that there was a report that there was some trouble in paradise between him and Robert Saleh.
Yeah.
Saleh?
Saleh.
You got it.
That there was an argument, and he's denying it. Do we think there's some trouble
Woody
in
Johnson
paradise?
Is denying that there was an argument with Robert Saleh?
Yes.
That's the story?
That's the story.
I would imagine that there is some trouble simply because they are involved so heavily with an organization as bad as the New York Jets.
It's a bad organization.
Really bad. Probably sometimes because of those two guys.
Yes. I think that there is trouble in paradise.
Okay.
So I don't know what if that answers your question, but I don't believe Woody.
You don't believe Woody?
Woody was doing all sorts of stuff meddling with Robert Saleh? No way. This is all fake.
fake news.
Yeah, I don't. When billionaires tell me things, I don't really listen to them very often.
That's a good take.
That's how I operate.
Yeah, I mean, if Aaron Rodgers is a representative for your organization in any way, shape, or form, it's probably trouble in paradise.
Bingo.
Because there's stuff getting said all the time.
That's Vice President Aaron Rodgers.
Nope, not anymore. Remember.
Stop saying stuff, Aaron. Mm-hmm. Stop it.
Finally, last night it was hitting the tables, hitting the sports book, and checking out Fremont Street.
Yes.
What are we thinking for tonight, fellas?
Great question.
Well, we're going to have some time. I do want to watch the game somewhere. We're going to saddle up and watch a game somewhere.
Well, that's why our dear friend Aaron, when he makes his triumphant return to the cabana,
we're going to inquire.
We have some questions about all those empty seats. For you.
Yeah.
There were so many seats.
Will they be empty tonight?
Will they be empty tonight? Probably not.
Now.
But it's not day one or day two of the college basketball playoff. Are people still into it as much when there's only four games all night long?
I think so. They're huge games. The question was, I mean, we got it. We do have to get Nick to the strip.
Yeah.
We do have to get.
I want to go to this. I want to be a strip boy.
Nice.
He wants to be a strip boy.
Yep, he does indeed.
And so the question is, when will we find time to do such a thing?
Slash, how do we do it?
Because tomorrow we're locked in. It's Creighton.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, guys.
Unless we watch the Creighton game at the strip.
Like at a sports book on the strip?
Yes, because then we don't have to wake up early on Saturday. We have lots of time on Saturday.
That's true.
Yeah.
But any sports book we find on the strip won't be nearly as good as this one.
That is
a great point,
Nick.
But I would entertain the idea of doing that. But we do. We have some things to figure out.
Yeah, I mean, here the first thing is
I don't think tonight we can vibe it out like we did last night. That ended poorly for us because it got me stuck on a kitty cat blackjack and all of us in bed by 9.
Yeah,
that was a horrible idea.
But we were tired.
I will say, I do think I want to watch the Rockies poolside tonight. I think that could be fun.
Poolside Rockies?
Poolside Rockies.
What time's the Rocktober play?
7:10.
7:10 here?
7.
Yeah.
So that's during the late games of the college basketball playoff.
Hmm. Well, then, maybe here is the place.
Man, I only have one pair of pants, and those are supposed to be airport pants.
If you guys want, we can make like a blackjack and split. That made
sense,
right?
Wow.
I mean, kind of. It does kind of make sense.
Wow. Wow.
Andrew gives us a recommendation on where to watch Creighton. I just want to be somewhere where I can sit and watch the basketball.
To be fair, I do enjoy that place that Andrew was talking
about. Oh, is it Circus Sports?
Yeah, I'd love that place.
Yeah.
Yes.
I do. Seriously, when Aaron comes back over here, I want to ask him about that.
Like, we got some questions, Aaron.
Questions for you. That's the other thing is Aaron would like to buy us beverages.
Aaron, we'll let you do that.
I'm going to say, Aaron, can I get a lemonade?
Hey, lemonade.
Josh, you not drinking kind of does put a damper on this whole thing.
A damper?
Let's get a Shirley Temple.
I don't want a Shirley Temple. I'd rather have a lemonade.
Or a Roy Rogers.
I don't know what's in a Roy Rogers.
What is in a Roy Rogers?
Remember, this is my life. I make decisions for myself.
I think it's cola and grenadine.
What if I didn't drink at all? Speak for other reasons.
Well, would you need water.
Would you still be? Oh my gosh, Nick. You haven't made any of those jokes all week. And now you do it now when we're hangry.
I'm hungry. I'm hangry.
This is unreal. Mm-hmm. All right, so that was how many questions was in that? Four?
Five.
Five?
There wasn't a lot going on.
We try for eight.
I know.
Every day we try for eight questions.
I know. I'm sorry.
Nick gave us five.
Make more
all you came up with was Robert Sala and Woody Johnson.
And also, what about the arena in Washington, D.C.?
Hey, how do we care about that?
We don't.
What if I came up with a content question right now?
Andrew says, I want a Nick blog, Andrew, of you guys riding the New York coaster. There's a roller coaster?
Yeah, there is.
I know that there is.
New York, yeah.
I've never been on a roller coaster.
Not much.
Okay.
Yeah, not much.
All right, Happer's got a question.
Here's a content question for you guys. I'll try and read it in Nick's voice. Golden State star Draymond Green on Thursday expressed regret for again being ejected, this time less than 4 minutes into the game. Has Draymond gone too far?
Oh, wow, that's a great question, Happer. I saw a funny internet tweet yesterday
nice.
About
I love
this.
Internet tweets.
Where it was Draymond Green watching the Zoom, whatever he had to his counseling, and it was this woman laying in bed, but she had this setup where she was
pretending to be on the Zoom.
I was like, that would be awesome if that's what Draymond was doing, just logging in but not participating.
You will never change this. That's what Draymond says.
You will never change this.
You will never change this. He cannot control himself.
No, he certainly cannot.
Even he can regret as much stuff as he wants to. It's not going to happen.
All right. Apper, that was a great content question. I'm sorry for disappointing you guys.
Oh, it's okay, Nick. It's okay. Just go. Where do you go for your content questions?
The Athletic, Reddit, ESPN.
Okay, I was going to say ESPN.com is where I go for like 90% of my questions.
Just so. News stories. That's news where stories. They are.
Yep. All righty. When we come back, time for What's for Dinner, and we will say goodbye.
Goodbye.
From Stadium Swim here at Circa Resort and Casino in very sunny Las Vegas. Just a few clouds in the sky right now here in Vegas. People are having an awesome time. We are having an awesome time. We will sign off and get you ready for the hoops next here on 1620 The Zone.
Live from the Host Coffee Studio, this is 1620 The Zone. 1620 The Zone. Traffic. This time-saving traffic is brought to you by the Nebraska Lottery.
Cash Blast from the Nebraska Lottery is back. Up until April 2nd, buy a 2x2 ticket and enter to be one of 14 weekly winners of $5,000 or $500. Details at anylottery.com. 2x2 top prize odds, 1 in 105,000.
You know what time of the year it is. Grand slams, no hitters, double plays are all back. Yes, baseball is here. And there's no better place to get in on all the MLB action than FanDuel. It's America's number one sports book. And right now, I mean right now, as we speak, new customers, you can start the MLB season with $200 in bonus bets, Nick, even if your first $5 bet wins.
That's $200 you can use to bet money lines, totals, strikeouts, homers, you name it, even player props, or combine your bets in a same game parlay for a chance at an even bigger payout. All on an app that's safe, secure, and super easy to use. Just visit FanDuel.com. Use the promo code ZONE. That's FanDuel.com/ZONE and join today. Make every moment more with FanDuel, official sports betting partner of Major League Baseball. 21 plus and present in Iowa. First online real money wager only. $10 first deposit required. Bonus issued is non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem, call 1-800-BETS-OFF.
Live in concert in Omaha. CHI Health Center, Friday, October 25th. With special guests, Gojira and Spirit Box. Korn. Get tickets this Friday at 10 a.m. at Ticketmaster.com. For more, visit KornOfficial.com.
What goes perfect with the madness of March? The convenience of Cubby's downtown in the Old Market, 13th and Jackson. And if you're gearing up to watch the game, Cubby's has what you need. You'll find a full meat counter with steaks, burgers, chicken, and homemade brats. Hot and fresh deli food, including Chester's Chicken and Godfather's Pizza Express. Pop, water, beer, and a full liquor department. See you at Cubby's Old Market, the very best in convenience. Open 24 hours at 13th and Jackson.
When I heard the words, you have breast cancer, I said, I have no idea what I'm going to do. My OBGYN called me and said, I know exactly what we're going to do, which led me to Nebraska Cancer Specialists. From day one, I felt that I was at the right place. There were some pretty rough times, but together we are stronger and they are there for you. You do not feel that you are alone.
NebraskaCancer.com.
Is your concrete cracked or uneven? Hey everyone, Coach Greg McDermott here to explain why you should choose EverLevel Concrete Repair. Many people think they need to replace broken concrete, but repairing it provides durable protection and comes at a fraction of the cost. EverLevel provides permanent repair solutions to fix your concrete and protect it against future damage. And it all comes with a long-term transferable warranty. They offer free inspections to walk you through the entire process. Call EverLevel Concrete Repair today.
Get ready for warm weather driving with early spring tire deals at Jensen. Save up to $200 on Goodyear, Cooper, General, Continental, Maxxis, and Kelly tires. Check out Jensen's early spring tire deals at JensenTireAndAuto.com today.
At Union Bank, people don't have your money. Your money has people. First Home people, investment people, people people, people who answer the phone and your chats, dream car people, dream retirement people, driving your dream car in your dream retirement people, small business people, credit card people, and all the other people you need. At Union Bank, Our people help you do more than you dreamed possible. So stop in and say hello. We can't wait to see you. Union Bank and Trust, member FDIC.
It's spring. Now is the best time to shop at Lenaha for all things garden or landscape. Our garden center is filled with the largest selection of homegrown plants, flowers, trees, and more. The area's best mulch and soil available for delivery and pickup. Rooted in quality, unmatched value. Lenaha Nurseries, 192nd and Center.
It's unsportsmanlike conduct.
Ali, ali, oxen free!
The 1620.
The Zone.
When you knock us down, we're going to get up, and on the way up, we're going to bite a kneecap off.
Crust is good on your pizza, not your ass.
I will eat your ass first.
He's tough as a Woolworth steak.
And then it's going to take two more shots to knock us down. All right, and on the way up, we're going to take your other kneecap.
I'm ready to hang them up, gut them, and skin them, and chop them up. You know what? I'm ready. My daughters aren't starving to death. I'll eat my neighbors.
And we're going to get up, and then it's going to take three shots to get us down. And when we do, we're going to take another hunk out of you.
Cliff, what are you going to take away as your best memory from playing basketball at Boston College?
Probably just, like, going out to eat.
All right, friends, it's time for What's for Dinner. By the way, Severe has texted us what he is enjoying tonight.
Michael.
Spicy, crispy shrimp.
Oh. Oh, I love spicy and crispy shrimp.
That sounds shrimp. Really, really good.
That sounds awesome.
We love shrimpies.
Are they breaded?
It looked maybe a little tiny bit of tiny baby breading, maybe. It's such a
close-up. Oh, yeah, there's breading on it.
Michael loves close-ups.
I think if I want crispy shrimp, I'd like it to be breaded.
Michael is funny. Michael takes horrible pictures of everything, except for excellent pictures of food. He takes great pictures of food.
He's one of the people that it's like his phone case is underwater. John used to John bought this phone case because it was in the era where everyone wanted the phone cases where you could, like, throw your phone somewhere. Yeah. It's like, but John, you're not going to throw it into the pool. You'll be fine. So John had this phone case, and he would take pictures, and Stibbs and I mocked him mercilessly. Mercilessly, yeah. Because it looked like it was underwater. Anyway, what we're having for dinner. We are having...
Yeah, go to this place website.
It's called 8 East.
Talk to me about it.
So our dear friend Aaron here, who's hooked us up and helped us out, he recommended it to us because he said the place to go is 8 East. And get the brisket fried rice.
Absolutely.
Diced beef brisket, stir-fried with garlic, egg, 8 East sauce, green and yellow onion. So we're going to do that, and then we'll probably split something as well. What do they call them? Small plates.
They have crab rangoons?
Do they have crab rangoons? They probably have to, right?
Things like that, crab rangoons?
I saw this, popcorn chicken skin. And I thought that sounds
popcorn chicken skin.
Yeah, where they fry the skin and they give it to you.
They skin the skin of what? The chicken?
The chicken, yeah. The popcorn. What about this, Happer? Sizzling shrimp. We were just talking about shrimp.
Spicy shrimp.
What about short rib dumplings?
Oh, absolutely. That sounds
great. Yeah. Duck rolls.
Yeah.
So, yeah. There's a,
I'd like to try. I've never had duck.
It's good, man. Very rich. So that's what we're having. Joey, what are you having for dinner?
Going out to Mantra out in Maple. Got to get some steak frites and loaded tater tots and some
steak frites.
Egg rolls. They got some good food over at Mantra.
Where's that at?
Over in the Benson area between 72nd and 60th.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, kind of a nice little fine dining area.
Joey, yes. Thank you, Joey.
Joey, I appreciate it.
Thank you for telling us that, Joey.
You're welcome.
What are we doing?
Annie says, I'd recommend some cool bars, but Josh will be in bed after dinner.
Yeah.
No.
This is what Josh.
Michael has sent another
photo.
Treat
Josh like a four-year-old. See, that's a good picture.
Great photo, Michael. Great photo. I won't be going to bed right after dinner tonight.
Oh, sleepy Josh.
No, we got hoops to watch. See, here's the thing.
Josh doesn't care about college basketball baseball or drinking. This is all the three reasons why we're here. You're like, ah. I can live without all that.
So then our bosses should listen to that and say, wow, there's a mature adult there who is not partaking in all of the wildness. He is keeping Happer and Nick in line. Look, I wanted to go to bed early last night because I knew we had today and tomorrow coming up.
But you hate lines. You were like, oh, why is it so cool that they line up on the baseball field?
That's not why I like baseball. That's the weirdest reason to like a sport.
It's got to be part of it.
They get in line.
They love
this.
Yes.
Is like the hockey dorks being like, oh man, they shake hands.
You love straight lines. You complain that the Nebraska marching band doesn't do it.
They don't do it. That's Nick. Solid argument. Jock Slap writes, chicken fried rice on the flat top grill.
Yeah. But we don't have access to that.
No, that's what he's having.
Oh, okay.
Or she. Or they. I don't know what
John. Oh, I forgot. I forgot that you guys ask other people what's for dinner.
Yeah, we like knowing what's for dinner.
It's like One Beer Friday.
Some people hate this segment, like Jimmy Allen. Jimmy, it sounds like he didn't like the segment about Jimmy earlier.
That's weird. We talked about Jimmy. You would think that he would like when the conversation's about him.
Yeah, exactly. Andy says there's a speakeasy in the basement of the Mob Museum, which is 5 minutes walk from you guys.
The Mob Museum, remember that?
I pointed that out last night.
This week's password is Izzy and Mo.
Andy, is he messing with us?
My guess is he's not.
How do you find out the password, though? How do you know?
He's probably up passwords.
do you know a guy?
Dude, we got to go to that. That sounds awesome.
Yeah, can we?
We know the password, Izzy and Mo.
All right, coming up on tomorrow's shows, we'll be back again at
Grums
at 10 a.m. Central Time, 8 a.m. Pacific Time for the Connor Happer Show. What's on the Connor Happer Show tomorrow?
The Connor Happer Show tomorrow is Friday, correct?
Yes.
That means we'll be talking to Munson, BC, and Sipple.
Awesome.
Sipple will be like, I'll talk to you guys on Friday.
So we'll have that tomorrow, and then we'll have Kent Walgamon. John
talking about the hangover
with Blossom, and then I think some other stuff too.
Yeah.
So
I think some other stuff for sure.
Perfect. For Joey, for Nick, for Apper, I'm Josh. See you later from Circa Sports. We appreciate them for having us again here at Stadium Swim at the Circa Resort and Casino in sunny Las Vegas. Back tomorrow. Have a great night. Goodbye.